seal grill, nigga. Get down, you can call me certified true. I'm the realest nigga. Spit the fire in the booth, my nigga. I'm on the quest for greatness. My perception is my reality. I don't fuck with snakes or fake bitches. I never shake their hands. I just dub them and snub them. It's on sight, nigga. I turn the slush land into mush land. This is not a joke, my nigga. You can get shot or stabbed or poked, my nigga. Every time I grab the mic, I'm dope, my nigga. The mainstream media manipulates your mind, selling hope, my nigga. I feel real, niggas. Get down, shit down, and they love it. That's not me. I was raised to never trust a fake bitch or fake nigga, my nigga. Real niggas get down, shit down, and they love it. That's not me. I was raised to never trust a fake bitch or fake nigga. On day two, I'm awake to what these bitches be saying. But it's always lies, it's not truth. These women support institutions that's not working for you. I work for myself, and as a man, I'ma stay 10 toes down, my nigga. As a man, my mind is free. I think for myself. Niggas think less and say less. That's why the stress today, my nigga. Looking through the fake world, social media, nigga. As I go outside and live my life.
All right, we are back, man. Mic check, 1, 2, 3. Let's hear it, sir. Let's see. All right, we're back. So we're talking about Diddy, home raided in Los Angeles, City of Angels. Please hit the like button, become a member, and subscribe to the channel. Please hit that subscription button. Let's go, man.
Story we're following, and of course we're trying to gather more and more information about it here on Live Now from Fox, as Diddy's home in Los Angeles has been raided by Homeland Security. Of course, we're learning more information. I do want to take you back out here before we get out to our Fox 11 team in their coverage, because some of this video is very dramatic, and we don't know a ton of information right now about this here on Live Now from Fox. Of course, breaking news of this,
it's over.
You can see potentially law enforcement officials and other officials just outside of a gate, this on a street.
Bro, it's over for him. Let me say this, you know, I don't think, I mean, he paid off Cassie, you know, for the violations when they're in a relationship. She was 19. We know the story. We see the evidence. We've seen how he treated her. There's videos. You can see that. But this is related to a sex trafficking investigation. Got to change the title of the story. But we shall continue. It is over for this media mogul. It is over for P. Diddy. For some reason, I'm starting to believe that as we're getting closer to the end of this decade, more things are becoming revealed. And it's amazing to watch. It's amazing to watch. I digress. Let's continue. Okay, let's go.
Near the Beverly Hills area, of course.
Done.
We're following it very closely on Live Now from Fox. And of course, we were watching this. We didn't know exactly what we were seeing at the time. So this is just a little bit ago, as you can see a crowbar to get through this gate initially as well.
Bro, look at, okay. Bro, if they're outside your house like this, I don't, what's going on, Outsider Media? What's up? Subscribe to Primo's channel. Outsider Media, what's up, dog? See Primo and audience. As my channel becomes more, you know, known, I bring people along. I don't forget the people that have been with me ever since day one. You know what I'm saying? I never forget the people that rock with me from day one. These guys seem like they forget it. And I'm a guy that's like, I like to engage with the audience. That's like me for the live show anyway. But anyway, they're outside his house. Yeah, man. They outside his house. Got the long guns ready for war. Media mogul, he's done. That's it.
As you can see, potentially law enforcement officials and other officials just outside of a gate, this on a street near the Beverly Hills area. Of course, we're following it very closely live now from Fox. And of course, we're watching this. We didn't know exactly what we were seeing at the time. So this is just a little bit.
Bro, they want you, man. Look at the crow. Let me rewind the footage. Look at this. Okay, they're outside his house, right? They got tactical gear on. They got the long guns on. And they're trying to get into his gate with a crowbar. Yeah, all love, bro. Always all love, bro. We're building something that, you know, it takes time, but we gradually, you know, ascending into the stratosphere. That's what I believe. Because my content is really, I don't know, it's very impactful. I think so. It's very impactful. People enjoy it, right? But anyway, it's over, bro. It's over.
Right. Other officials just
game over. You know, I don't have a game over clip. Do I have a clip of game over? No. I have that. I don't have that, but it's game over.
Outside of a gate, this on a street near the Beverly Hills area. Of course, we're following it very closely live now. Of course, we were watching this. We didn't know exactly what we were seeing at the time. So this is just a little bit ago as they, you can see a crowbar to get through this gate initially as well. The long guns and a multitude.
Oh my God, look at this. Soon as the gate opens,
to get through this gate initially as well, the long guns and a multitude of people, as you'll see, they'll zoom out a little bit just to see the amount of
You know, I have to ask the question, why are they coming after Diddy? Why are they coming after Diddy for allegedly, you know, sex trafficking when there's literally sex trafficking going on down at the border from these, you know what I'm saying, coyote cartels? What about the arrest of those? What about the arrest of those, you know, these migrants that come over across the border illegally? When they come across the border, they say they're going to meet their parents. And, you know, they're not, then the government is taking them to meet their parents, but they're not meeting their parents. They're being trafficked. But where's the arrest of this? Where's the arrest of this?
The force they are using to get inside this home. And of course, the complex in which this home sits is a very expansive one for the American rapper.
And what is Diddy?
You can see them checking inside.
And by the way, let me hold on. Okay, by the way, I want to say this. Money doesn't make you invincible. Let's play that clip by this one.
That's $250,000 you're holding right there in your hand. Over $4 million in here. First day on the job, you hit a $3 million seizure.
Wait, he said four.
Ah, taxation without representation, brother. Nothing's free in this world.
Nothing's free in this world. Taxation without representation, brother.
That's $250,000.
That's the point.
One for the American rapper and producer. You can see them checking inside a vehicle. We don't know exactly what is involved, if Diddy's even there. We don't know a ton of information about this at all, but this is a dramatic video coming in of the Los Angeles home there.
Yo, look at his complex. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Look at his complex.
Raided by Homeland Security. Some of those images there on the.
Okay, so what? Okay, let me go over what Diddy got. Look at his complex, bro. He got the G-Wagon. One car is covered. Then he got the Range Rover here. He's got his golf carts. I've seen videos of Diddy driving in golf carts. And that's his front gate. Wow. That's his front gate. Wow.
You can see them checking inside this developing story out of.
And they got the helicopter out there.
Los Angeles.
And then detain those three people inside. We haven't seen any signs of P. Diddy himself. Again, we're hearing that he is possibly in New York, but several people inside the home that will surely be questioned. Very chaotic scene when all of this happened. Lots of neighbors wondering what's going on, of course, and we'll keep you updated. But it's definitely going to be quite a scene here for the remainder of the day.
Yeah, when you see this number of law enforcement agencies coming together.
Look how big that house is. Look at that property. From here to here to here to here. And guess what? Diddy's property is gone just like that. see the property, they can take it from you just like that. And that's what they're going to do. That's what you're seeing now. Look, could you imagine you work all this hard to own all this stuff? You own all this stuff. And now you have federal agents at your door coming to arrest you.
When you see this number of law enforcement agencies coming together, making this type of raid to such a big, high-profile mansion, like
that, what I'm saying? Look at that. Bro, you got your private pool. You got everything, right? You got, you know, the, right? You have a border, right? Diddy got a border around his house. He got his own border around his house. Look at the border. I'm surprised he doesn't have a helicopter pad. But before we continue with this, bro, we got to go to Diddy's Diddy's Halloween thing, The Darkest Night. I don't think he's The Darkest Night tonight, my guy. Hold on, let me find it before we continue. I don't think he's The Darkest Night tonight. I don't think he's The Darkest Night tonight. Our world is done, bro. Hold on. Okay. Okay, so Diddy does have a YouTube channel. Okay, hold on. Let me screen share this. Let me screen share this. Okay, hold on a second. Okay, here we go. Let's go. Let's go back a little bit in time.
It's Hassan.
He's looking at the right? I can't believe it. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. So this is Diddy playing The Darkest Night. Around Halloween, this is his channel. Look, if you go to new comments, look what happened. Look, 55 minutes ago. They laughing at him 55 minutes ago. Look, they got a police thing with a smile emoji. A laughing emoji. This video did not age well for Diddy. I got to post in this. This is fucking... This is amazing. It's amazing. Anyway, man, I digress. Hold on. Let me put this in the. I can't believe it. Hold on. Let's post this link here. He can't delete my link because he's going to jail. He's not gonna be doing nothing. He's gonna be in jail, my nigga. And by the way, I don't wish jail upon any man. You know what I'm saying? I really don't. But if you're violating children, if you're violating this consequence, you're going to have to pay, bro. I'm just keeping it real, man. Anyway, let's go watch The Darkest Night. Diddy got kids, man.
I'm tired of mediocrity. Of the shortcuts. Of the greed. Of empty suits telling us that we don't deserve more. What am I to do, Big?
You go hard. When they doubt you, you definitely gotta go hard. When you fall hard, that pain gonna make you grow. The world needs you, they need you. It's time, come on.
Son, what the fuck is going on? There's a flickering of lights in my office. Where are the security guard? Get him in here now. What the? At my fucking desk, okay?
Oh, what the fuck?
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Oh, what the fuck?
In the strike.
No, what are you doing?
Negotiations.
Is that what you want?
Shut the fuck up. Motherfucker. Say the strike is over.
The strike is over. All right, the strike is over. Okay, I said it.
They say you either die a hero, or you live long enough to see yourself become the villain. And if that's what it takes to stand up to oppression, break the system and stand for love.
Big Bugs!
I guess you could call me a villain then.
So is the deep state calling Diddy a villain? I don't know. Maybe the deep state is calling Diddy a villain. I don't know. Maybe the deep state is calling Diddy a villain. Anyway,
like this in a neighborhood like this as well. This is very thought out, methodical, planned out for days. So they base this on a number of information gathering that they've received and evidence or what they're looking for. So clearly this is not something they do lightly. They really go through the process of making sure that everything is ready before they conduct a raid like this. So yes, this took a lot of planning for all these multiple agencies to come together to actually now conduct a type of raid like this, as you're seeing right now with this street also shut down for the
right. The darkest night is living like this, and he's got federal agents at his door. Told you, man, when you get to that level, there's so much that comes with it, man.
Time being, because
people say that when you're famous, you're literally stuck in prison. People literally say when you're famous, your mind is like you're a prison. Sorry, you're a prisoner to your fame. That's what it is. You're a prisoner to your fame. You own all this stuff, and federal agents are knocking at your
door. Haley, you could see the perimeter has been set up in that neighborhood to keep just the public back from the work that's being done. And there you have the shot from Sky Fox. Again, these heavily armed vehicles right next to all those luxury cars. You already see a Porsche, a G-Wagon, so many luxury cars right there on that property. So it is a very differing juxtaposition there of what you're seeing. But look at this mansion here in Holmby Hills where the raid is taking place. Again, we don't know what exactly they're looking for, who they're looking for. But again, this could possibly be linked to a sex trafficking investigation involving rapper Sean Combs, the music executive. But as you heard from Haley right there, she believes and she's been hearing that we do not think that Sean Combs is on that property at home right now. He may be in New York as this raid is being conducted. But we do know from our reporting that over the course of the year already, just as early as March this year, there have been several lawsuits filed against Sean Combs. So clearly this could be part of it. We are not sure at this point. But again, Stu, if you could hear me, what are you seeing right now in terms of your point of view?
Well, again, we saw some of those officers right there at that one of the back houses. They did bring a ladder in. They actually went out and brought that ladder into that property. You see it right there. And then they brought another ladder. So there's probably something inside this building right here that they are very curious about. Or they were, like you said, it was very well planned. They knew they were going to need that ladder to make access. So there is something inside this piece of property in the back as one of the back houses that they have been very interested in getting at. We haven't seen them bring anything out. At one point, I can say, and when I keep saying that we didn't see them bring anything out, we did see them bring out what looked like a big plastic bin, but I don't know if that was something that they had brought in with them as far as possible tools that they needed. But that was the only thing that was seemed to be out of the ordinary, and that did come out of that back out.
I think they're raiding his cells, knowing that he's not home, to gather up whatever case they're building. That's what I
house that we just showed you. This is that front area.
Yo, these are deep state agents, bro. Look, they're deep state.
Possible tools that they needed, but that was the only thing that was seemed to be out evidence of the ordinary, and that did come out of that back house that we just showed you. This is that front area we were just talking about moments ago. Right. We watched as those Bearcats made their way.
Right, Andrew Tate, Donald Trump, P. Diddy, Jeffrey Epstein.
up Mapleton to make the, to actually do this raid. And then we watched as officers were getting through one of the pedestrian gates over here on this side of the property. Once they had breached that, well, then they opened those gates up right there and those armored vehicles rolled in. They were very quick in whatever they needed to do to seize that home. That garage door went up very quickly, and it doesn't seem to be actually a garage inside there. We've been trying to peek in with the camera every now and then. It looks like there's a large table inside there, so that might have been an office area or some sort of staging area, and that's where we believe that most of the people that we see in custody came from. At least that's where we watched them exit this building with the officers early on when this raid was just starting. As it stands right now, you've got plenty of these armored law enforcement still walking the property. You see see them walking in pairs, a lot less of those weapons out, so they are less on the defensive as it would be. And you can see them just kind of making their way through that property. But I can tell every home that's on here, meaning there's three major homes. This one right here, there's a couple of officers still inside there. We know at least one officer is still inside here. So they're still standing guards.
Yo, let me ask you this question. Why are they looking in this bin? Why would Diddy be hiding there? A multi-million dollar person, and you have Diddy hiding over there.
We know at least one.
Oh, is Diddy in here?
One officer.
I don't know. Is Diddy in there?
Still inside.
Come on, man.
Here, so they're still standing guard. So that whatever it is that they're doing, this isn't over by any means. And I think this is probably just getting underway. They just want to make sure that all these buildings are secure. And if there is anybody on this property, that they are in custody before they actually start whatever it is that they're looking for. But again, as you mentioned, very well planned, very quickly executed. And of course, a number of officers out here. I couldn't even venture to say how many of these armored officers that
but this is the same thing they did to Donald Trump. It's the same playbook. They show up at your house when the person is not there. It's the same playbook. Have we not learned anything, bro? It's the same thing that happened to Trump last year. Come on, man. This is crazy.
On the property, you can see them right there. And this is just a small group. That was also one of the things. As soon as they made their way into that pedestrian gate, the first thing they did was open up all those doors on that Range Rover and then made their way into this portion of the home. And that's that garage that we've been talking about. That garage door went up very quickly. And of all the people that we've seen come out of the building, that's where they all came from.
I couldn't imagine.
They walked them out. Put them in this little corner right here, and that's where they've been questioning them ever since.
Another ladder, as you were mentioning, a couple of ladders on site as part of.
Look at the woman here, bro. I don't know if it's his girlfriend or wife or whatever, but she got her hand over her head, her mouth, and everything. Right? Look at the fatigue this guy has on. Look at the fatigue he has on. Look at that, bro. Bro, it's like there was a terrorist attack out in Russia. You see how they tortured those terrorists? Like, I don't know, man. It's, bro, I'm telling you, man.
This raid, I don't know.
As a black man, as a man living in this country, you're not free. You're a slave within their system. You're a slave within their system. That's what I believe. You're just surviving at this point.
What they're looking for or where they're trying to reach. But we did see somebody carrying a ladder, the second one on the property right now. It does seem like there are three different buildings on this property, the main mansion.
Right. So that's his son, I think, arrested with federal agents. That is crazy. That is crazy. Look at the lady, look. It looked like she's seen a ghost. Gee, man. Said, bro, you got to pick and choose what you want to do in life.
And then two guest houses, for lack of better knowledge in terms of what they are exactly used for. But yes, two smaller type houses on the lot as well. And of course, the pool right there in the middle with the grass. Lawn. So clearly, this is going to take time. And that is why probably there are so many personnel on site to go through everything and do the search that they are conducting. We, again, don't know.
Diddy's comments is turned off on Instagram. I'm just looking now. All his comments are turned off. You can't comment. You know, so. Oh, wait, here's one, but comments are limited. So I don't think you can comment. Right. So, you know, hey, man.
A lot of information in terms of what evidence they're trying to collect, who they're looking for, absolutely, or why, absolutely, they made the raid to begin with. But again, this could possibly, absolutely, be involving the sex trafficking investigation. And again, when we get more details, of course, we'll bring it to you. But this is going to be a while. You see the Department of Homeland Security officers right there in that bear cat. You know, this could be phase two of what to do now, what they're searching for, and making sure they have all their information they need when they conduct a raid like this and go through the process of going through that property. It is a big mansion indeed, owned by Bad Boy Films and one of Sean Combs's children. So,
you know, I know the story, you know, about, you know, Diddy allegedly paid, you know, the guy that was arrested. You know what I think? The guy that was arrested for Tupac's murder, allegedly, he probably gave them some details, bro. What's his name? It's not Shitty Cuz, is it? I don't know what his name is, man. What's his name? Hold on. Yeah, this guy. He probably gave them some information, bro. Because federal agents wouldn't have arrested him. And allegedly, you know, he told. Right, like it says, Tupac Shakur murder suspect makes first court appearance, and allegedly, yeah, Dwayne Davis. So I don't know. Allegedly, you know, he's the one that killed Tupac, and he said that Diddy paid him to go and, you know, delete Tupac. That's what I heard. So he probably told something.
Get your space back with Garage.
To take less time, bro. Oh wait, hold on. I think Suge Knight has a. Suge Knight has a podcast from jail. Suge Knight has a podcast from jail, my guy. I was looking for, hold on, let me see. And Suge Knight has a podcast from jail. And okay, hold on. Suge Knight. I don't know. This is what he's saying. This is what he's saying from jail.
I'm Dave Mays, and this is Collect Call with Suge Knight. What you're about to hear, Suge will be putting periods to all question marks.
Nick Cannon called me. He told me that Deion had reached out to him after.
First of all, I'd like to thank God.
It's like this. Boys with Puff, before I even jump on that situation, it's like the whole thing, even with the Keefe D shit.
For 27 years, the family of Tupac Shakur,
there we go,
Shakur has been waiting for justice. We are here today to announce the arrest.
I used to jam to that.
Dwayne Keith Davis, a.k.a. Keefe D, for the murder of Tupac Shakur.
You know, yeah, I know a lot of people feel like I was saying, like...
Yo, Suge Knight has a podcast from jail. Right? He's on the phone. They record his voice. This is what I think, right? He's on the phone. They record his voice. And then they generate an AI of Suge Knight talking. It looks dope. It's dope. It's great thinking, bro. It's great thinking. But he's talking on this. Look.
Free Keefe D. And they understand why I said that. I for one, there's prison on nobody. And I say that no matter who it is. Two, in Keefe D situation, we know each other. We got history. And he ain't built that type of way for us. One of those rah-rah type of niggas. Not saying that's good or bad. But it's like this.
Hey, Keith, Metro Police.
If any of this shit is true, And I ain't here to say what it is and what's not. He more safer in prison than he is on the street. You know, in prison, it's a lot of protection. You know, you can only do so much. You know, you got guards and everything else, I'm quite sure. You know, we get the utmost best treatment around. On the streets, any given day, anything can happen. God is forgiven, but the streets are not. So a lot of people are more safer in prison than they are on the streets. So that's doing more justice in prison than the streets. And, you know, I had guys that's real tagged with from Spook Town and other places. A lot of people said some things about the cost of their freedom, and they all know what it is. For us on his end. But for us, the Puffy situation.
Some even speculated COMBS was involved in Tupac's death. He denies that.
You know, I really, really, really gotta have a real conversation with Snoop. And I know I got a bro named Jaime. He said he'd be coming to Mike. It's like Mike's show. He said Snoop just a prop. They speak.
They're all props.
But that's another shit. The reason why I gotta have a conversation with him about is that I've been doing that young dude a long time. He ain't young no more, but I've been doing it since he was a young man. And I did everything in my power to make sure he kept his freedom.
Murder was the case that they gave me. I'm innocent.
For almost 2 years, Snoop has been out on $1 million bail.
So, you know, man, I think all the fruits are the roosters are coming home to roost in 2024. Okay, so let's go to more of this Puffy stuff. Crazy, man. Raided by police. Right? Everybody's talking about it. Right? This is why I was watching, right? It's over. Right? So this is Miami. 50 Cent calls Diddy gay on the Breakfast Club. Right? There's some Candace Owens news. Right? There's me there, which is awesome. Right? I think Cat Williams on Diddy. Bro, it's crazy. It's crazy. Anyway.
In life, some things are certain. Like your long-lost father coming back the moment you finally met.
First, we have some big breaking news. Raids being carried out in several homes belonging to Diddy as part of a trafficking investigation being led on the Southern District of California.
Eyewitness News reporter Jim Dolan is following developments for us. Mm. He is in the newsroom. Jim?
Wow. This is a developing story. The details of this are still a little unclear, but what we know for sure is that federal agents are searching a home in Holmby Hills, California, that our sister station, KBC-TV, says is associated with Sean Diddy Combs, the hip-hop music mogul. There's a raid going on at the same time of Miami's of Combs's Miami area home as well. It's not yet clear what the investigators are looking for in either home. This video was taken from a helicopter above the Holmby Hills, California estate, and there two people were taken out of the home in handcuffs. It's not clear yet if they were arrested. Federal sources tell ABC News that the investigation is being carried out in connection with a human trafficking investigation. Jesus. And here's a look at the scene in Miami, Florida, where authorities are also on the scene of his home there. Diddy has been accused in recent court filings of sexual abuse and forced drugging, even beatings that stem from allegations in the 1990s. He has denied all of those allegations. One victim said that Combs met her at a Harlem restaurant in 1991, drugged her and took her home and sexually abused her, and he videotaped that assault. Again, Combs denies those allegations. Just one more time. At least two homes associated with Sean Diddy.
Two homes? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. It's over, man. Told you guys, don't put yourself in these situations. And then here's the news here. Okay, so there you have it there. Yo, look at that. Yo. Yo, I never thought I would be witnessing what I'm witnessing now. Let's play this video on this side. Diddy's homes in LA and Miami, right? So there we go. Diddy's homes in LA and Miami are raided by Homeland Security as part of sex trafficking probe after mounting lawsuits. After mounting lawsuits. But it's a lawsuit, like, provide evidence. Like, I'm always saying devil's advocate shit because you got to provide evidence, man. But this is the environment that we live in now anyway as a man. So, you know, I don't know, man. I'm just saying. We want evidence, man. Okay, here we go. Oh, there's no sound to it. I think that's a drone. Yeah, they have a drone up there. Hold on. No, it's not going to let me skip ahead. Okay, there we go. So, yeah, they have a... it's probably the... Yeah, I'm not going to use this one, but they have a drone up there. I just want to get you guys some of the images here. So you got that image, you got that image, and then you got this one. That's his sons, I think. At least two of, as now, unidentified men were seen being put in handcuffs at the Homely Hills property. And then we just played that. Okay. Yeah. So we got to keep playing some of the Sky News shit.
Is it every piece?
Let's put this up here.
A person.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's over, man. I'm telling you, when they're ready, when the deep state's ready to come get you, they come get you, man. The only way to get out of this nightmare. I don't want to talk about the only way to get out of this nightmare. Just understand that you have to live in this nightmare and you have to, like, be able to, you know, maneuver through the nightmare. All right? Just maneuver through it, bro. All right? All right, here we go.
Reports that a Homeby Hills mansion linked to music mogul Sean Diddy Combs was raided by Homeland Security agents.
KTLA 5's Rachel Minitoff joining us live now from the scene with more on this breaking story. Rachel?
Lou, Glenn, we've seen federal agents in and around the home working together with local law enforcement. And from our chopper view, we saw several people questioned outside of the home, and some have even been detained. There's a lot of activity out here. Choppers up above. Take a look at what we're seeing from the ground. You can see that LAPD has blocked off this entire street, which is now filled with media from around the world, as well as onlookers. Homeland Security Investigations, or HSI, out of New York, says it executed law enforcement actions as part of an ongoing investigation. And from afar, it looks like there has been a raid of one of the homes on this street. Take a look at the video from our chopper of the activity this afternoon. This is the 200 block of Main Home came back to Bad Boy Productions, which is his company, belonged to Sean Diddy Combs, or P. Diddy. A car at the home came back to Bad Boy Productions, which is his company. According to TMZ, P. Diddy's LA and Miami home are both being raided. The outlet says this appears to be tied to sex trafficking allegations, which have been levied against Diddy in recent months from different plaintiffs. There are several divisions here, including HSI Los Angeles, Miami, and local law enforcement, but this is being led, I'm told, by a division out of New York. Not a whole lot of information at this point. We don't know who's here at the house and whether or not P. Diddy himself is here. We did receive a statement from P. Diddy's accuser's attorney in response to reports of a search warrant that was issued. It says, quote, "We will always support law enforcement when it seeks to prosecute those that have violated the law. Hopefully, this is the beginning of a process that will hold Mr. Combs responsible for his depraved conduct." Back out here live, it's obviously a very active scene.
So Cassie got paid, though. She got paid. Cassie got paid. Like, the whole point of why we're playing this is because Cassie got paid. She got her money. Let me pull this up. And I don't understand it, bro. Like, Cassie got paid. Like, how does this warrant all of this? And no, I'm not a Diddy fan. Or, like, I'm pro-man. You know what I'm saying? I'm pro, you know, male empowerment for sure. But Let's go over to her. Let's go over to comment section. I want to see it. I want to see it. Let's see. Okay. So this is Cassie. Let's see it. Watch, watch. When you click this, you're going to see recent comments. Hold on. Hold on. Watch. You scroll down. Okay. Hold on. Let me see. Scroll down. Look right there. Yo. Yo. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. Let me put my tag in here, though. Guys, we're going to read the comments from what women are saying about this situation. Okay. I got to put my tag because we are using this. All right. So we're going to read some what we're going to read some of the conversation of what women are saying about this situation, right? Okay. So let me zoom in. Okay. So let's, okay, hold on. You guys can see that, right? Okay. Yeah. You guys can see that on the screen. Okay. Here we go. Watch this. Okay. How do we get the, oh, okay. I got to do it this way. Okay. So look, you'll see 18 weeks, right? Right. As you scroll down, right? 17 weeks, 18 weeks. All right. Watch what the women say. Look, 18 weeks. Now, 3 hours ago, somebody put, "You finally win, queen. More power." Okay. That was a dude that said that. Look, somebody said, "We did it, Joe." Carrie Hilson said, oh no, that's, yeah, Carrie Hilson. Okay, so that was a couple weeks. Okay, so moving on, it says, "You open the door, we believe you." That's what this person said. That was a dude. "Just here to thank for opening the floodgates." Another person said that. Okay, 18 weeks. Let's go down. I think that's it. But there should be more, though. I know there's going to be more. Oh, here we go. "I guess you happy now." That's what this brother said. John Gibbons. He says, "I guess you happy now." 4 hours ago. "And make sure you take the stand, too. Don't let him intimidate you more. You got this." This is what another person say with 15 followers. Okay, moving on down. Let's see. Okay, I think that's it. 18 weeks. But they're gonna flood her comments for sure. But this was the ex-girlfriend. She got paid. She got paid her money. I guess she has a, let's see. Oh, okay, that's her best friend. I mean, so you know, I guess they saying, you know, a woman's trauma warrants federal agents coming into your home and arresting you once you pay her. Once you pay her, it warrants. And then here's the cut. Okay, so it says all the allegations against Diddy. All right. It's a lot to read, man, but we can go through it. So in November 2023, the singer Cassie, real name Cassandra Ventura, filed an explosive federal lawsuit against her former partner, Sean P. Diddy Combs, claiming he had been physically and sexually abusive throughout their relationship. Okay, that's in 2023. The complainant alleged that Combs' abuse ranged from beating Ventura, forcing her to have sex with other men, to raping her at her home in 2018. The rapper settled the lawsuit within a day. But since then, three more women and one man have sued Combs, accusing him of a wide range of abusive behavior, including sexual harassment, rape, non-consensual pornography, and sex trafficking. Situation escalated on March 25th when federal agents with Homeland Security Investigations raided Combs' property in Miami and Los Angeles. Multiple outlets reported that the raids were connected to a federal sex trafficking investigation based out of New York. The music mogul has denied all accusers' allegations, claiming they are attempting to assassinate my character, destroy my reputation, and my legacy. Here's everything you need to know about the civil cases against him. Cassie alleged she was the victim of a pattern of abuse, violence, and sex trafficking. That's what Cassie alleges. All right. So it says Ventura sued under New York's Adult Survivors Act. That's the act that we got to read to. Okay. I don't want to subscribe to this. Can we get rid of this? I can look it up though. Hold on. It's an important piece because they changed the law. That's the same law that, you know, went after Donald Trump with E. Jean Cole. It's the same thing. The same thing. So it says, the Adults of Ours Act, which gave victims a one-time, one-year window to sue their alleged sexual abusers and institutions, even if the statute of limitations had run out. And that's all you really need to know, fellas and ladies. But I think this is only in New York, though, right? Oh, I can't even underline it. So if the statute of limitations is over, a woman can still come go after you. That's crazy. And if you pay her the money, she can still, well, not her, but federal agents can come to your house and raid your home through other allegations from other women because they want to get paid too. But again, if you violated women, you should pay a price. That's what I say. You know what I'm saying? If you violate, you have to pay a price, bro. I mean, the world does not operate where you can just violate people and just get away with it. I'll say that. But the Me Too movement is very powerful, bro. Right? The Me Too movement in collaboration with the deep state. That's what it is. That's what it is. That's what I believe. Right? It says the complaint also claims that Diddy forced Ventura to have sex with male sex workers in different cities. Encounters, she says he watched, masturbated to, and recorded. The singer says she never went to the police because she was afraid that doing so would merely give Mr. Combs another excuse to hurt her. She also alleges that following a dinner in 2018, Combs forced himself into her apartment and raped her while she repeatedly said no and tried to push him away. Ventura says she ended the relationship for good afterward. Bro, you can't violate women, bro. Not in this country. This is not Saudi Arabia. Right? Osada Meter says E. Jean Cole is a crazy freak show. She said she thinks grape is sexy. She said women fantasize about it. What a nut. Yeah, she did say that. We could play that clip. E. Jean Cole. Oh, E. Jean Carroll, sorry. Hold on, let me do a reaction video to the Anderson Cooper the clip. I don't know where the clip is, man. But she said something like that. Hold on, let me see. I think it's
the competition is sending.
I don't know. Let's see if we can find it. So this is somebody that's a victim.
A New York moment. Like,
oh, one of the those best things. New, just like the best New York. Donald Trump is going to put on a filmy bodysuit. It's like, oh, I couldn't. So let's go in the dressing room. I thought, yeah, I'm going to make him put those pants on. Walked in. And the minute I was in there, he shut the door and pushed me up against the wall and banged my head on the wall and kissed me. It was so shocking. He put his shoulder against me to hold me against the wall. Really? And at that point, I realized that I was in a very difficult situation.
Did he say anything?
No. It was just like, we're going to do this thing.
You know, man, you know, this might sound mean, but I believe E. Jean Carroll is a crackpot. I think she's a far leftist extremist. I do. And I do think that E. Jean Carroll could be fabricating her story. All right. That might sound mean. People might disagree with me about that. But I believe what I believe.
We're just so hot for each other. Why would I even try to think what he was thinking? Anyway, so he pushed me, you know, held me with a shoulder, and I was wearing a coat dress and tights, and he pulled down the tights.
Given the prior.
Yeah, I don't believe it. But anyway, we could disagree with that. Okay, so moving on, we covered some E. Jean Carroll stuff, the crackpot lunatics out here. But back to Diddy. I think there's some video of Diddy. Right? Like, you know, there was some video. I don't want to play it, but I think there was. I think this is him and Cassie, right? 5 years ago. Diddy and Cassie in their angelic meta outfits, 2018. Diddy, Forrest, and Cat. This was on Art of the Dialogue. Diddy forcing Cassie into freak off sessions is true. Diddy is swinger. He had a session with Ja Rule. They say Diddy on the run. Longtime friend of Diddy, accuser speaks out. Okay, here we go.
Flossing does more than you think.
Crazy time.
Producing flags. Music mogul and rapper Sean Diddy.
Could you imagine, when was this? 3 months ago. Look, and look. If I click to new comments, watch what happens. Boom. 20 minutes ago. It's coming. Don't worry, Tiffany. Look, 20 minutes ago. Thank God. Thank God about time. Yes, karma. Who's here after today's raid? This is how they think. Look at it. Look at this. That's a real hair hat. Diddy is a monster, though. When you serve Satan as long as Diddy has been Satan, okay. Right? This modern woman says she's definitely telling the truth. Having a freak off against your will is absurd. So sad for people that got hurt by this man. I mean, if you got hurt, I mean, you got to pay a price, bro. You know, but I talked to, Lady Law, and the notion of believing all women. Women lie. I mean, I've exposed their lies on my channel. So, like, how do we know? How do we know that they're not lying, bro? To get resources from this man, because he already paid out 30 mil. Right? Women lie, men lie, numbers don't lie. That's the point. But anyway, I digress.
And rapper Sean Diddy Combs has faced four different lawsuits in recent weeks alleging sexual assault and abuse, all of which he has denied. The first of those came from singer Cassie Ventura, known as Cassie, who accused Combs of sexual abuse and sex trafficking during the decade they were together.
I know.
NBC's entertainment correspondent Chloe Malas spoke exclusively to a longtime friend of Cassie's who said she witnessed some troubling incidents. Chloe?
Good evening, Ellison. Singer-songwriter activist Tiffany Redd had been working with Cassie on an album when she first met Diddy, and says that she witnessed him verbally abusing her friend.
Oh my God. She witnessed him verbally abusing her friend. And let me guess, she didn't stand up for her friend back then, but now since Cassie got paid and is speaking out and is talking about her trauma, now she has the courage to. Probably.
Following Cassie's settlement with Diddy, Red penned an open letter in Rolling Stone about her experience. She spoke to me about the events that she says traumatized her.
It's the same shit.
I don't think people understand what it's like to be traumatized by somebody famous and rich.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Do I have to play the clip of what Trump said about? Let me say this. I think that's why modern women despise men supporting Trump, because Trump said, when you're rich and famous, women let you do whatever they want. Women let you do whatever you want to them because you're rich and famous. And so the rich and famous dudes are the high value men that women want. And so now that they get the high value man, which is rich and famous, and he violates them, I don't understand their concept. I don't. I just don't.
Because you can't get away from them.
Tiffany Redd has written for the likes of Zendaya, Jason Derulo, and Jennifer Hudson. In 2015, she became friends with Cassie while writing songs for her album. At that point, Cassie and Diddy had been together for nearly 8 years. In a lawsuit Cassie filed last month, she detailed the abuse she says Diddy committed, including physical assault. Redd says although she did not know about the...
I don't know where I went, but I was thinking of something. You know, I'm just going to play devil's advocate on this case, right? You know, I'm saying all men, if you are physically abused by a woman, if you're verbally abused by a woman, you should file suits. That's what I believe. You should file suits. Yes, you should go out there and file suits because you are you have trauma too.
The alleged physical assault of Cassie, she did witness verbal abuse on more than one occasion, one of which took place during Cassie's 29th birthday in 2015. Red says Diddy showed up at karaoke where Cassie and a group of friends were celebrating.
So he had her back into the corner and he was like cussing her out with his hand in his fit in her face.
Yo, man, these are the same R. Kelly type. You know what I'm saying? They just jump on the bandwagon, bro. Some of them do. I'm not going to say all of them. But they jump on the bandwagon. It's the same playbook of R. Kelly. It's the same thing, but a different person. It's R. Kelly. Hold on. Let me play that Boondock. Hold on a second. Let me play that Boondocks clip of R. Kelly. It's the same playbook, bro. That's what this shit is. Okay, here we go. I'm going to show you this right quick. Hold on a second, and we'll continue. If you're watching this broadcast, please hit the like button. The like button is my friend. So please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. But let's go look at some R. Kelly stuff. Oh, they took the video down? This video contains content from Sony Pictures. We blocked it in your country on copyright grounds. Wow. Can we play this one?
Join your local Tim's for more than just serving coffee. Learn transferable skills. Apply now.
Relieve your 10 worst cold and flu symptoms with Tylenol Complete.
Maybe R. Kelly did urinate on this woman, but America urinated on R. Kelly. Oh. And if you let them put this man in jail, America will urinate on each and every one of you. Salaam alaikum.
Alaikum salam, brother.
Please, people, you saw the tape. The girl testified she was underage. You're not allowed to do that to a little girl. We have a videotape.
Go tell that to your white bitch.
Mm-hmm. But the girl was... prosecution rests. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, all that needs to be said is this.
Right, that's exactly them, bro. You play R. Kelly's music should have got him out of jail. It didn't. Diddy being a mogul, it's not gonna work, bro. It's over. It's over. Game over.
Later that night, Red, who was...
Oh, wait. Hold on. Let me play a game over clip, too. Let me just do that, and then we'll continue. We're in 2005 that happened. We're in 2024, and it's still happening in real life. Crazy. Game over. Let's see. I'm looking for it. I don't know which one I want to use. Oh, he used the Mario one. Game. Can't believe it, man.
I'm talking about.
Game over, Diddy. Game over. Okay, let's go back to this lady's story.
Staying at Cassie's home, says she awoke to screaming.
He's standing in the living room area, and she's there. And he was like, emotional singing, bitch, there you are. And I just was like, oh, he's talking to me. And I remember, like, I don't know if you know what his voice sounds like, but like, I felt like I was in the presence of his monster inside. And I remember like looking in his.
I was in the presence of his monster inside?
Like, I don't know if you know what his voice sounds like, but like, I felt like I was in the presence of his monster inside. And
what does that mean, man?
And I remember like looking in his eyes and I said to him, what did y'all do? Because I could see that she was like really sedated. That was the first time I'd ever seen her like high before. And then he says, tell your girl she wants some birthday. And we were like, well, I mean, he's saying this to me. And I'm like, well, she doesn't have to have sex with you if she doesn't want to. He was upset. Like, you know, I guess that she didn't want to do with him whatever he wanted. I don't know. I don't feel like I could advocate for myself in that moment. Like, I realized, like, oh, this guy is dangerous.
Red says it was only a few months ago that Cassie told her what was really going on that night in 2015, that it all stemmed from the music executive wanting her to take part in what he called a freak-off against her will.
What did Cassie tell you about these freak-offs?
You know, that he would hire these, like, sex workers and, like, they would have, you know, sex with her or whatever, and he would watch and tell them what to do.
In her lawsuit, Cassie alleges she was forced to participate in freak-offs throughout her relationship with Diddy. Red learning recently one horrific detail from Cassie.
She told me the only time he was willing to do anything or work on her music, go through any plans, any of that, was when she had a freak-off. So all of our music, all my work, to find out that, like, I spent all these years writing these songs for him to rape my friend to, like, is just disgusting.
In the lawsuit, Cassie detailed the physical abuse she says Diddy committed, including an instance where she was put in a hotel room for days to heal. Red says Cassie recently told her about Diddy giving her a black eye before the premiere of her 2016 film, The Perfect Match.
I remember one time her telling me that, I think it might have been The Perfect Match, that movie that she was in, and she told me that she had a black eye under her makeup.
Do you believe Diddy is a dangerous person?
Yes. I do.
Well, there you have it, guys. Society has collapsed. The women, not all, but some, they're not on the same pages with the men. And if this woman believes that Diddy's dangerous, I guarantee she believes that all men are dangerous. That's just my humble opinion. My humble opinion.
Why? I mean, look at his rap sheet.
An attorney for Cassie declined to comment. Diddy's attorney did not respond. In 2015, Diddy was arrested on 3 counts of assault with a deadly weapon and other charges for allegedly beating up his son's football coach. Prosecutors declined to file felony charges related to that arrest. 24 hours after Cassie filed her lawsuit, she and Diddy announced that they had reached an undisclosed settlement. Combs released a statement saying, "We have decided to resolve this matter amicably. I wish Cassie and her family all the best."
Yeah, dog. You might have done that. 30 mil, I think it was. But bro, that was your worst decision. But then if you're violating women and she has proof on you, she got the dirt on you, that's another worst decision.
Cassie and her family, all the best. His lawyer adding that the settlement was, quote, in no way an admission of wrongdoing.
I mean, I just feel like it's PR. He's settled because he doesn't want to go to court.
Diddy's music career.
Right. He settled because he doesn't want to go to court. But yes, today they raided his house. He is going to court. He is going to court after paying $30 million.
Spans 3 decades, including 3 Grammy Awards and the creation of Bad Boy Records, representing artists from Mary J. Blige to the late Notorious B.I.G. In September, he was awarded MTV's Global Icon Award. But since the allegations surfaced, Hulu scrapped a reality series about his family, and the Recording Academy said they are considering to rescind his invite to this year's Grammys.
You know, I think a lot of people, especially in the Black community, are, you know, I've seen the narrative of, like, you know, they just trying to take a Black man down. And it's just like.
But they are. I mean, it might not be fully related to this case, but they are trying to take a Black man down. They're trying to take the Black man down. Let me say this on camera. They're trying to take the Black man down. They're trying to take the Asian man up. But they're trying to take the Black man down. They're trying to take the white man down. They're trying to take men down, period. That's what they're doing. Like, that's what they're doing. They're trying to take Donald Trump down. They're trying to take now P. Diddy down. What about Joe Biden and the crime family? What about Joe Biden's crime family? How come they're not taking them down? Oh, okay. Quiet crickets, right? That's the point. That's the point. They don't want a father in the home with women.
Like, that's not what this is about. That's not what this is about. This is about accountability and a reckoning. Like, that's just the bottom line.
As for what
reckoning's coming.
Justice looks like?
I think justice looks like Diddy being behind bars. And I also think that justice looks like...
He paid the money. Why does he have to go to jail if he settled on it? I don't understand this. I mean, somebody's got to explain it to me. I'm going to drop my link, man. I want someone to explain it if you want to call in. Explain to me why Diddy should go to jail if he settled the gripe. Why should he go to jail? He paid and he should still go to jail. He might as well just say, F it. I'll just send me, you know, because whatever choice he made, he's still going to jail. He pays, he goes to jail. If he doesn't pay, he goes to jail. You know? But anyway, the link is there.
Like Diddy being behind bars. And I also think that justice looks like everybody getting retribution for all of the things, the amount of therapy. Like I just said, all of the moments, the time, like these are our careers.
Anyway, I digress. Let's go talk to some of these ladies on this case. I want to hear what they have to say. Yeah, Terrain. Okay, your device is connected. What's going on, man?
Yo, bro. What? Yo. I don't understand how.
Oh, he's a baddie boy? Someone said he's a baddie boy. Probably. I don't know these niggas' sexuality. I don't study that shit. What's going on, bro?
Yeah, like, why is it that a lot of these women, all of a sudden reveal that these things happen? Like, I don't get it. It's 2024. Why now?
Because I think because inflation is eating them alive. They have to work four jobs. Mm-hmm. Their career is not enough. It's not enough. Some of them have if some of them have been victimized by some man, you should be penalized for that. You should pay a price for that. And right. My line, Diddy paid a price. He paid $30 million, and they're still at his door. That's why I keep saying the government is illegitimate. That's it. It's a two-tier system, bro. That's what I believe. They go after Donald Trump.
Mm-hmm.
There's always a thing called the honeypot situation where they bring women and they use the women to get closer to the high value, the high powered man.
Wow. And this puts a really bad name on men. Like now that all these stars
is,
you know, being victimized, whatever you call the word. It's like now all the women is being feminist. This is the point.
That's right. Traditional relationships are done, bro. More or less.
Damn. This shit is insane. This shit is insane.
Oh, it's done, bro. I'm telling you, I live in Canada, bro. I go out and I see it. And I'm like, yo, this is amazing. This is the act that now if the statute of limitations is over, they can still come after you. There it is right there, bro.
Really? Damn.
Yeah, they made it. It said, which amends state law to allow alleged victims of sexual offenses for which the statute of limitation has lapsed to file civil suits for a one-year period from November 2024 to November 2024-23. The act thus expands the ability of plaintiffs to sue for sexual assault and unwanted sexual contact in the workplace. But this is why they say it comes out of New York.
Damn. Right?
It comes out of New York. And the conspiracy theory is that they amended this for to come after these guys, like to come after Donald Trump, to come after, you know, prominent celebs.
Damn, that shit is insane. Damn. That's just, yep.
So I keep saying, bro, what are you willing to do, bro?
Honestly, I'm willing to just do me. Do what the heck I gotta do, because I don't even understand all this crap.
Yeah, they just changed the law, man. Bro, I told you before, man, the government is illegitimate, bro. We the people. How did we get... You know, I was thinking earlier today, like, this is what I mean. Like, this is in Canada right now. This is exactly what I'm talking. Welcome to Canada, where many Canadians can't afford food, but a refugee family of four receives rent paid monthly, $3,185 for furniture, $1,250 for clothing, $750 for housing needs, $450 for basic needs. And it goes on. But this is Canada.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Jeez.
So there's more. Oh no, is this in Paris? Yeah, this is in Paris, I think.
Oh, I thought that was in Russia. Oh.
Look, this is Justin Trudeau. Look.
Oh no. Yeah.
Crazy. Bro.
What the heck?
But the point is, like Alex Jones posted, now arrest the Epstein list. He's right. Sean Diddy Combs, Los Angeles, Miami homes are being raided by federal agents. And he says, now arrest the Epstein list. The people that are on Jeffrey Epstein's list, you should arrest them. I agree with that. Absolutely. But they won't. They won't.
This shit is crazy. Look at all of them. Damn. I wonder why he wasn't even home. Nobody was securing the place.
No, he probably has family or something like that, or... You know, the people that work for him, or whatever, living there. But him being home, bro, he's a businessman. Businessmen are never home. Businessmen are out making business. You know what I'm saying?
True. Right. Yeah. Bro, I told you. Right.
A lot. A lot of people think having a lot of money makes you safe. It doesn't. It never did. You're under the microscope of. Like, you know, they want to pay attention to everything you do. Everything you do, where you live, you know what I'm saying? All this kind of stuff. They want to pay attention to everything you do.
Yep. That's what it is. That's what it is.
So, you know, people strive to be rich and famous. That's why when a guy says, oh, I look at your microphone. And it's like, dude, what does that have to do with anything?
Yeah, he a beta simp.
What does that have to do with anything?
Beta simp. That's exactly what he is. That's what he was.
Right?
Beta like, and the simp.
Yes, you are all wrong. And it's a bunch of them. All the, you know, the NPCs and the cogs in the machine.
Every time you say that, they say, wait, what?
Yeah, I'm going to use different terminology because they don't get it. They never will get it, bro.
No. They don't get it. They'll never get it.
So I don't waste my time. I don't waste my time. No. No.
Exactly.
Look, more than 400 AGO workers walk off the job on Tuesday after contract stalls fail. Some more protests. Yeah, more
Damn. Hold on, bro. I'm gonna be right back. I gotta call my boss. Hold on.
Yeah, man. Make the call. And you shall last long. Okay, let's.
I'm gonna be back.
Yeah. Let's see.
I'll sweat it down. Yeah.
If you want to join the show? You can just, you know, hit the the link. The link will bring you in. Okay, we're just looking for a call to ask some questions. What's going on with Diddy? What's going on? What's going on? So, Diddy was arrested. Are you for this or you're not for this?
I don't really care. That's not my life.
Don't know, don't care?
I don't care. I don't care.
Have a nice one. We got to find people that care. Okay, that's good. Oh, I think someone tried to call in. I don't know what happened. They went boop.
We had rain today.
Yo, what's going on?
Chilling, what's up?
What's going on? A prominent celebrity was arrested. Do you care?
No.
I'm a gossip queen. Who's that?
I don't know what that means, man.
Yeah, like what?
I care.
You do care?
Yeah.
Okay, so what are you doing to fight this?
Fight what?
Never mind, man.
All right. Like what?
Bro, I keep telling you, these are people that just don't get it. It's just funny. I'm just making comedy now. I'm just asking questions and just making straight up comedy.
That's so crazy.
That's all I'm doing now. I'm having fun making comedy videos and just keeping it. This is not real shit. This has never been real shit.
Wow.
This has never been right. Like, bro, I see it out there, bro. You see when I debate them, you see what happens. They block you. That's crazy, right?
Yep, they block us. I couldn't
believe the man blocked me because I asked him a question.
I think she did it. She did it. She did it. The girl.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
She got the girl did. Because they're cogs in a machine. That's what they are. Anybody with a different opinion that doesn't believe their narrative.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
You gotta think how they think.
Exactly.
It's crazy.
And they don't get it.
Certified truth.
Wow.
They're not on here to talk, bro. And if you send your money to these below average attitude chicks, I feel bad for you. I wouldn't send them a dime.
Oh, she stepped.
What's going on?
Not much. What are you doing?
I'm chilling. So Diddy was arrested. He was his homes were raided. How do you feel about this? Due to abuse and, you know, him violating an ex-girlfriend.
You know, I don't know too much about what he did. I haven't even read about it yet. I just keep seeing the headlines. But I guess he deserved it.
Okay, let me ask you this. Okay. Mm-hmm. There's allegations against a guy, right? And you guys settle on what the allegations are. The guy pays you out. Do you still want him to go to jail?
If you want him to go to jail, then don't settle it that way, right?
That's what I was saying.
I mean, To have both?
That's what it is. It looks like both.
It does.
Because he settled. He settled the $30 million. You know, he paid the $30 million. It's like, have a nice day. And now the federal agents are knocking on his door. So I'm asking you as a woman to find out, like, if a man violated you and you said, yo, pay me, I want to be compensated, and he compensates you, do you still want him to go to jail?
So it depends on how much I was impacted, right? If I had some kind of trauma triggered where I lost income and all that stuff because I was not able to get over it, and I needed therapy and all that stuff.
Yeah, they said that was involved.
So that is like, you caused all this and you also should not be in society because you're going to do it again. Then yeah, I understand.
You think the person would still continue doing it?
Yeah. Oh, fucking hell yes. If they get away with it once and they're at that point where they need to do something to violate another person to enjoy themselves, like, it's, that's when it becomes dangerous because you're pairing it with sexuality.
Yeah, but don't you think that it's dangerous that OnlyFans exists, where we're seeing women naked? It radicalizes weak-minded males. Don't you think that's dangerous too? Like, even just this app itself, I'm not using you.
No, because it puts the onus on the woman, and the onus is not on the woman. The onus is on people themselves for themselves, right? What I do
is not violate people.
If I make you do something without putting my hands on you, you can blame someone else all you want. That locus of control, that idea that someone outside me controls me, that's when you become helpless. That's when you develop a victim mindset. And that's dangerous for any person.
I agree with that. You know what I mean? Yeah, I can agree with that. But I'm saying, like, he paid, right? He paid the $30 million, and now federal agents is knocking at his door. And I just say, if that's the case, just come and arrest me if that was the case. What do I have to pay to be arrested? It makes no sense, huh?
Is it because of the same person?
No, they're saying a different accuser came out. But I believe that different accusers will come out. I said that on that stream I did months ago when talking about this.
So in that case, yes, because that person wants justice carried out that way. And he did it twice. More and more.
So are you saying...
It all comes down to, like, you don't do it, period. How the person chose to respond to what you chose to do, it's their business, right? And no longer because...
So are you saying believe all
Trump?
Are you saying? Oh,
no,
you're kind of.
I didn't say that. I didn't say that.
No, I'm saying. Are you saying?
Talking about Trump for a second. Huh?
No, I said you were lagging. So I was saying.
Oh, no. I'm saying about Trump, for example, right?
Yeah.
I was just commenting today on how it's amazing that somebody could potentially be your president. I don't know if you're in the States again.
No, I'm in Canada.
Right? You're in Canada. Okay. So they're American's president again, even though he's going through this whole thing where, like, he's paying hush money, right? He paid hush money that trial, and right, he has to pay that certain amount, right? Yeah. And of course, it's very convenient. It's all happening at once. It's not impacting him the way you'd think it would. It's actually, he's doing well, right? As far as I know.
So you think, right? Donald Trump is doing well through the hush money?
No,
payment?
No. I'm saying that, like, there's a chance he might get elected again.
Okay.
Okay. So all I'm saying is, there's no shortage of actions he's taking resurface in the future. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, he's behaved that way throughout the years by choice. It's just catching up with him.
Are you saying it's catching up with Donald Trump?
Yes, and it could catch up with him. There's probably people who haven't said anything that one day could, if they wanted to. But maybe it's just...
And I think people are liars. I think people lie for fame, fortune, and a treasure chest. That's what I believe.
Yeah.
I think Donald Trump being elected president, I think that's a good thing for America. I do. Because
I'm not even going to argue with you there, because I don't have like a
his policies. I'm a policies guy, right? I'm not a Republican. I'm not a Democrat. I'm an independent. Mm-hmm. I'm about policies. If he has good policies, which from what I'm looking at, when he was president, the policies were good. America was thriving for the pandemic. Yada yada yada.
You kind of have to be a bit removed, or I don't want to say callous, but callous. When making these decisions, you're not worried about whose feelings are hurt, or doing what needs to be done.
No, it's law. It's logic over feelings. It's facts over feelings.
One thing I noticed about him is he because he's a people person, he'll like it looks like he's trying to get the vote, which he is, right? But he understands every demographic's like pitfalls, like what they're struggling with, and. Yeah. I mean, if he fixes it, I don't know, but he's at least recognized it, right? So I don't know. But back to the thing, you're asking me about Puff Daddy or Puff Daddy, P. Diddy, right? I'm sorry, I'm old.
How old are you? But
how old am I?
Yeah, how old are you?
I'm 34.
Yeah, I mean, we're roughly the same age, man. You know, old is like 60.
Just because I'm saying, I'm dating myself by calling him Puff Daddy, not Diddy.
But let me ask you this. Do you think Donald Trump is a threat to democracy? Do you think Donald Trump is like Hitler?
I wouldn't go that far. I think that he's a character for sure. Like, he's got no filter. That can be a good thing. It can also be a bad thing.
I think it's a good thing. I think a president speaking on what he sees and what he believes and standing on his square, I support it. I don't want Obama telling me stuff to make me feel good, to not hurt my feelings.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I don't want, right? I don't know. Allegedly, Obama, this is all alleged, of course, violated the Logan Act because he's a citizen. He's not supposed to go and speak with other prime ministers. He was just in Ireland or I think the UK talking to a prime minister. What's he doing there? He's not supposed to do that.
I don't know. I didn't know that.
Yeah, right. So, you know, and then, you know, allegedly they say his wife is a man and all this kind of stuff. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? They say a lot of things. But Donald Trump, in my opinion, he stands on a square and he speaks on what he believes. And I respect it. I do. I respect it. I've always respected it. But, yeah, anyway, I digress. Good conversation.
What? Web certified truth? I'm sorry. I just noticed that what you were talking and I had to say it so I could pay attention to this man. Sorry.
Yeah, dog. She's not interested in you, dog.
Mind your business. Who are you talking about? What's going on? How are you?
I'm doing good, but I'm talking about the last guy. I mean, you're not interested, are you?
You be nice. Okay, but you have to be very selective, Missy. Very selective.
In reality.
Oh, I'm talking to somebody else. Oh, are you rude? Is that why you're getting kicked?
So what's going on?
Wow.
I don't care. They can't kick. Bro, they can't kick what's going on in my real life, my personal life. They can't ever kick that. They can't kick what's going on when I'm in the gym doing my workout routine. They can't kick that. You know what I'm saying? When I'm putting 110% in, can't kick that. Because guess what? They can't kick inflation or the housing. They can't kick a housing affordability. How about that?
Oh.
Well, man, they can't kick nothing because that's how they live.
Boo world. Exactly.
Exactly, right? Politicians are all fake. We need a man of the people. Turtle is a giant ventriloquist dummy. That's exactly what he is. You ever see him be mad? Like, you need to get one of your brain and had a Nazi
turn problem. It up.
Had a Nazi problem. I don't know if I can find that clip. Yeah, she's. You see how she got her chest out like that? Like, what the? What kind of message are you sending?
Right.
Come on, you don't
have the chest, anyways.
What? I got boobs. Oh my god, I have boobs. You guys want boobs, right? You guys, you know, every man loves boobs. Okay.
Right.
You're gonna put them in the camera for donations.
OnlyFans. That's what that is.
Sickening, man.
OnlyFans.
That's how these women look at life. I don't know what to tell you. I think this is the video. Listen to him yelling. Watch it.
Is flailing in every way to try and get the attention from
watch.
That his members voted against
a request, bro,
by President Zelensky himself to support a Canada-Ukraine free trade deal. The reality is his
constituents
across the country feel betrayed by the Conservative Party voting against Ukraine. Voted against Ukraine, voted against Ukrainian Canadians, voted against the reconstruction.
Yes, voting against my tax dollars going to Ukraine. We need to fix the problems in our country. But listen,
the reconstruction of Ukraine that we are committed to through a free trade agreement. He stood in this house and voted against Ukraine and is now trying to do anything he can to hide from it. He let down Ukraine and that shows who he is.
Bro, that's a dictator, bro. I don't care who you are. That's what I believe.
Wow.
You hear him yelling like this?
Crazy.
Come on, bro. That's, you know, yeah, he's young, he's getting passionate. I do it too. But come on, man. He's not telling the full story. And there's one more thing before I continue.
Nah, this he ain't so.
One more thing. So you guys hear about the terrorist attack in Russia.
Oh yeah, the 40 people. Yeah,
40 people, right?
So, oh my god,
I was looking Saturday night. He did not. Okay, so me, like myself, I don't want no war. I want peace. I have the sign back there because I want peace, right? I want peace. Mm-hmm. I want peace, bro, right?
Mm-hmm.
This guy said nothing about the terrorist attack on civilians. He said nothing. No. I went through it, and he said nothing. Look, he doesn't condemn the attacks against the Russians, right? I condemn it. There should be no attacks against Russians, even if we have a disagreement or whatever. But he didn't say anything.
He
didn't say anything. Look, I'm looking. Look, the only thing that he posted, right, was this one on March 3rd, the heinous attack on civilian life, right? So he's talking about civilian life. Canada condemns Russia's latest missile strikes on Ukraine and civilian cities. Okay, fine. That's your side. Okay, I agree with that. You should condemn it, right? On both sides. That's how I look at it. But he doesn't say anything about the Russian terrorist attack. Nothing. Look.
Wow.
Nothing. And look, watch this. You want me to show you this? Look. People were in his comment section saying, how come you're not going to... Look. Look, hold on. Hypocrite. Hold on. Let's see if we can find that one. Right? I gotta look for it. This is all in French. But it was in here in the comment section.
And, right.
Look, Prime Minister, it seems we're not getting our money back from Ukraine. Resign. But yeah, there was a... They said, oh, why are you not going to condemn the attacks against Russia?
Damn, what the heck? So that was scary.
He condemns the attacks, right? He condemns attacks on Russia attacking Ukraine, but Russia being, he doesn't condemn none of this. I condemn both sides. I don't want people to be, like, you know, attacked and civilians and all that stuff. I don't know. This is on the front side, but. No, he doesn't condemn none of it. I looked. I said, yeah, okay. So you're just team what your team is. That's crazy. I don't want war for Ukrainians. I don't want war for Russians. I don't want war for Canadians and America. But he just said for Ukraine. As if the terrorist attack didn't happen. They called it, killed 140 people. Why isn't he out there condemning it? He's not going to do that. He's not going to do that. So that's why I said, that's why I say in my song, the narrative. I don't believe their narrative because I don't.
Exactly.
Right. And the lyrics.
I don't believe their lyrics.
The lyrics.
My summer weather sucks ass.
What?
Summer weather. It's going to be like
100 plus degrees out in Cali, Vegas, Arizona.
110 to 120.
Right.
And sometimes I walk home in it.
Sometimes I walk home in it.
Devils reject. Hello. Michael, hello.
Sometimes I go home.
No, Carly.
Dabba 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 doo.
And drywall on the walls and fluorescent lighting ahead of you and no privacy at all. What's the message? The message is really clear. You mean nothing. You are replaceable. You are a widget in a bin awaiting assembly. You're just a cog in a machine.
I don't even know what you look like. Can I touch your face?
Of course, Diana.
Oh, God. Oh, God. What is this? What is all this? Am I touching the outside of a house? Oh, God. You're a monster.
I'm beautiful on the inside.
So what's going on, ma'am? Do you believe the last guy you talked to is beautiful on the inside?
Who, me?
The last guy you talked to, do you think he's beautiful on in the inside?
Yes, I think he's a pure heart. He is one of my donors.
Has he donated to you?
Donated what?
Diamonds or money or anything?
No, but he's donated his time to me. He literally used to hang out in my streams 24/7, comment, make it fun in there, and I respect that a lot. He has not gifted me a lot, and I don't even expect that from him or anyone, honestly, but he literally is one of my day oneers. He started with me when I was new on the app again in 2020, and he made it lit in here.
So does he want to date you?
I think everyone wants to date me.
I don't. I don't want to date you.
And to each their own.
But you said everyone. I don't want to date you.
I'm sure everyone.
I would fuck you, but I don't want to date you.
That's okay, too.
Thank you.
Yabba dabba, alo. Randy, alo.
Take that to the bed.
What's up, yabba dabba?
What time is it where you're at right now?
10:30.
I never knew on a Monday afternoon at 10:30 at night that beautiful could look so wonderful.
Sam.
What's up? Thank you.
He's doing it.
I'm just doing the
Goofy laugh at me.
I can do Goofy and Mickey.
Do
Opie.
Look. Opie.
Oh, boy. Oh,
can you do Opie?
Oh, my can you do God. Opie? That was so
that's not
true.
That's not the best one can I can do, Opie? Though. I got two more. Have you ever seen the new movie, It?
Can you do Opie?
Yeah. Hiya, Georgie. Do you want to do it? This is even more creepy. Watch this.
Can you do Opie? Can you do Opie?
Wild! You're going to have to hop back in and do the other one that you're talking about. Flavio, Carlos, Jesse, Alo.
So, ma'am.
Can you do Opie?
Ma'am, you literally are talking to Opie. It's funny.
Everybody comes in here and I talk to everyone.
But you're not willing to date any of these guys, though.
The right one will come around. But even then, I feel like in real life, I would find somebody in real life.
Like, you know, like while you're doing your everyday thing?
I'm a work from home mother, so, you know, depends.
What do you have to offer a man in a relationship if you found that guy?
That's a good question. I feel like I can give anything that they want. You know what I mean? So whatever they,
like what?
Whatever they want, I think I can adjust to as long as, you know, they work with me as well. It goes both ways.
But like what? Give a specific example.
Look at that face. That was good. What was good? Okay. Yeah, but that
okay.
Was
do you ever watch Family Guy?
No.
I do watch Family Guy.
Okay. Hey, here we go.
You ever watch Family Guy? Okay. You ever watch Family Guy?
Hey there, Chris.
I don't even know what you look like. Can you touch your face?
Of course, Diana.
Come here, you son of a bitch. Oh, God. I have orange popsicles
in my face. Oh, God. What is this? What is all this? Am I touching the outside of a house? Oh, God. You're a monster.
I'm beautiful on the inside.
Yeah, but Rocky, there's a limit.
Can you Durant do that? That's what I would say. I would say that. True.
Oh my god.
You doing
god.
All these other stupid crap. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we got something. Can you hear me?
Like, literally. Like,
literally. Hello.
Like, what's going on?
Who is this? You're pixelated. I can't see you.
Like, literally.
Yeah. So what's going
like,
on?
What's your...
Are you single?
Wow.
I am single.
Are you single by choice?
Yes.
Or you can't get a man? Which one?
No, I'm single by choice.
Do you have a dog?
No, I have three cats.
You have three cats?
Mm-hmm. I became alcohol? The crazy cat lady in my profile.
Do you drink alcohol?
Occasionally.
Only when you're like kind of at home alone thing, kind of thing?
Yeah, when I have no responsibilities, which is rare, but yes.
If you could find a man, what would you bring to that man in a relationship? Other than sex and you know, your intimacy.
Well, I already have everything that I need. So it's going to be more so what can the man add to my life?
He can
because I already got a job. I got my own shit. I got everything. So, like, we got to be partners in this.
Okay.
Like, so you see what I'm saying? So whatever, whenever, if ever, I decide to get into a relationship, it's got to be with somebody that will complement my life. We complement each other's lives. There you go. But it's got to be, I'm good being alone. So your presence needs to make me feel better than when I do when I'm alone.
Yeah, but you're not really good when you're alone. You're isolated from interactions with men. That's a dangerous pathway to being a person that you can't pair bond with. It's a very dangerous action. It's unactionable at this point.
I wouldn't say so necessarily.
Your career is more important than you finding a man and building with him. Inflation is eating you alive. I can tell by the look on your face that you don't know what is going on when it comes to the food prices.
Oh, trust me, I do. I don't give food stamps. I pay for everything my fucking self. I do.
Wouldn't it make sense to have a man that you trust, admire, and respect to come in there and take half the load? That's all I'm saying.
That's why I'm saying, and to your point, that's exactly why I said, if I'm going to, I'm tired of passenger princess men, okay? I'm tired of being the one that wears the pants in the relationship.
What is that? You wear the pants in a relationship? That's not men.
That's what I'm saying. I'm tired of wearing
the pants in a relationship. Yeah, I hear you. That's not men. Those are weak-minded, feminized dudes. Men lead by force.
That's why I'm saying I don't need a passenger princess. I've already had those. They did not add any value to my life. They did not bring me peace, and therefore they are not in the picture anymore.
Wow.
No,
that makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. I feel you. You know, you're being honest and I respect it, but ma'am, you know what I'm saying? There's men out here that are going through the same question period that you're going through.
And I think it's not just a man or woman specifically that go through those periods.
Oh no.
I'm of the mindset, like, if you're not contributing to, if you're not adding value to my life, why do I need you? I don't need somebody that's going to detract from my life. I want something that to add to it.
I hear you. I'm talking about people that would be bringing value to your life. Where do you think these men normally hang out at? The ones that are that can bring value to someone's life. What do you think they hang out at? Hang out on dating streaming services and call you beautiful 24/7 or want to donate to you and get nothing for it. They don't do that.
No, I mean, clearly, I'm not here for dating. I'm not here for donating. Look how many diamonds I have. I ain't got shit. I'm here to have some, when I say adult, meaning other than talking to my children. Oh.
Okay. Okay. Bro, we know what the stakes are. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, we know what the stakes are. The partner thing doesn't work for women. I mean, this is what I'm saying. Primo singing the song. Strong and independent. Say they don't need a man. It's a lie. It's a lie.
Nah, she's really like, I can already tell by her disposition that she is straight up masculine. So there's going to be a reason why they can't get one. They can't. Like they don't even have to ask themselves the question of why. Like, you already see these YouTube content creators, they be like, you know, posting TikTok and other, you know, women that interview other women, and it's like they're in their 30s, and you know, they just in the same bracket. Like, come on now.
I think there's a video here that we could. What the? Oh, okay. So Alex Jones put, "Get Over and Escape from New York" is not just a fantastic film; it's now reality. Okay, let's see what this.
This giant goose is forming, and I'm like, I was literally just walking, and a man came up and punched me in the face. Oh my god, it hurts so bad. I can't even talk. Literally, I fell to the ground, and now this giant goose is forming, and I'm like, oh my god, it's so crazy.
Okay, maybe. Okay, here, look. I need a relationship as strong as that coach. Look at this. Look.
Wow.
This is funny, boy. The segue is exactly what we're doing right now. Look. They all fitting around. Look, look, listen, listen.
Yep.
They're pretending like they're having such a good time without men. I don't think so. I don't think so.
Oh,
they're pretending.
This is
they're pretending.
They do this on dating apps.
Fuck. There's a lot of weight there. Hopefully you guys are on the bottom floor. It won't cause any havoc there. God, I need a relationship as strong as that couch. Yeah, you guys look phenomenal. You guys all look healthy and great. I love you. Okay. What the fuck is
oh my god.
Bro, god. Them dealing with their other girlfriends is more important than them getting a man and moving on with their life and building. Bro, it's crazy. Anyway, any other thoughts on this, man?
Bro, I'm done. I can't. Like, this is too much. Like, ain't no dating. Where the dating at? Where the dating at? Where is it? Where is the traditional dating? Where is that? I can't find any of that. I just can't.
Well, bro, I believe you'll find it. You need to go to a church, and you need to deal with like-minded people. I will only deal with, like, in my personal life, I will deal with like-minded people. I will build relationships. I'll you know what I'm saying? I'll extend an olive branch to like-minded people that have morality. My morality is the most important thing to me. I don't give a fuck about the money. The money comes with whatever, but my morality. And so, bro, that's what you gotta focus on. I have another quote, right? I'll find that in a second, but I just wanted to show you the house prices out here in Toronto.
Oh, shoot.
Like, they can't buy a house. They're not doing this.
Holy shoot.
Look, $1 million.
A million?
2 million. Four bedrooms.
Damn.
Yeah, bro, look.
Million?
1 million.
Millions, though?
Look, 99999999. Okay, so let's, you know, I gotta do more research to find out what cities, right? Yeah. So you could go to this website and find out which one it is.
Damn, that's crazy.
Yeah. Oh, man.
That's crazy.
But bro, Christian, let me see. I think Christian women in relationships have a different.
Wow.
See, like living in accordance with Christian values is about being kind, gentle, modest, and giving. This is what she's looking for in a partner. And that's why she's chosen to spend time with you. As long as you're willing to be open and supportive of one another, your relationship should be a success. That's all you got to focus on, bro. You will find a pathway. That's what I believe.
Right.
What's that?
I said, that's right. That's what all these people should have, the same kind of mindset like that. But they just feel like the grass is always greener.
Yeah, but it's how they're raised, right? Some of them are raised with no morality, no moral framework. So now you're just seeing the decay of society, the breakdowns. The simulation is breaking down. You're seeing your simulation breaking down, bro. That's what it is. You know?
Damn.
Yeah, the simulation is breaking down, bro. So, you know, like, you want to be married? You want to get married? Like, when do you want to get married?
Gee, I feel like I should get married in my 40s. I don't even know, to be honest. Man, I mean, I would say now, but then again, and I don't know. I'm doing too much.
Look, told you, your society is breaking down, bro. You're in New York, right?
Oh, yeah.
Were you, like, not, don't tell me exactly your address. But where part of New York are you at?
Oh, Manhattan.
Okay, so you're in Manhattan. Bro, look, there's another story. Look.
Holy shit.
Look, man, this is it right here.
Oh, shit. Oh, I heard about that one. I was going to tell you about it, but yeah, there it is.
Right. 45 was taken into custody after allegedly shoving another man onto the tracks before an oncoming train station. The suspect was reportedly described as an emotionally disturbed person. Bro, these cities are dangerous, bro. Too much hatred in these cities. That's why I live outside the city. Yeah, man. Well, you know, Primo says, I'm done with the relationship game. Peace, quiet, and freedom for life. I'm on that page, too. I told you, getting vagina is not at the top of my list. It's just not. Let me ask you, Turan, are you still there? I don't know if I can hear you. You still there, bro? I can't hear you. Yeah, I don't know. I think you cut out. Yeah, I think you might have dropped off. But getting vagina is not at the top of my list, man. It's just not. If it comes, it comes. If it don't, it don't. Yo, are you there, bro? I can't hear you. Yeah, I live in, Primo says I live in a bot's fort, and it's dangerous. Very dangerous. Yeah, it's dangerous, bro. You know, I go about my business and stuff, but I just keep to myself. I learned to just not start stuff with people unless really warranted. Like, I'm not going to go out there and just push a random dude on us. I'm not doing any of that. I'm just living my life to the best available, like, to the best of my abilities and surviving through the highest levels of inflation. That's what I'm doing because it's the highest levels of inflation. They lied and said they keep printing money.
Uh-oh. The electric thing.
Like, how are you going to keep printing money?
What's up,
Izzy? they want to get the carbon tax high.
Yay.
Because they want to keep funding these wars. What's going on?
What do you say?
What's going on? How are you?
I don't got time for your bullshit. Stop sucking dick, bro. Go get a life.
Hello,
go
I find a
female that has pussy. Go get pussy.
You should come visit me in Australia.
You never know. Where in Australia are you?
What's going on?
Not too much. How are you?
Doing good. Do you think a man's top priority should be to live to get vagina?
No.
Do vaginas clean themselves?
No.
Are you sure?
No, it depends. Like, of course, to a degree, but you still have to clean yourself.
Okay.
Like, you still have to shower and wash yourself, but I'm sure inside they clean themselves, right?
Yeah. I heard that, you know, I was reading this thing. They said that women believe that they don't have to clean inside. And they believe, some women believe it cleans itself. Is that true?
No, I use a shower. No, I'm all in there. Like, I clean myself real good.
Good. That's the kind of woman I date.
Oh, so what are you saying? You got a clean pussy?
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Look at this shit.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, that's
yeah, good. You got to take care of that.
Yeah. This is crazy. I've got a big cock for you.
Oh my god, this is crazy.
We don't need to talk about that right now. No.
Okay.
We're good. We don't need to be talking about that, you guys.
But with me, we don't talk about it.
But yeah, you guys are a frisky bunch tonight, eh?
No, not frisky.
No, we're good.
Real question.
No, nah, so I'm just sitting here, I'm stroking my cock, you know.
Oh,
you're
man.
What?
I said, I'm sitting here stroking my cock.
Oh, don't tell me that. I don't want to know that. Okay.
You don't want to
yeah,
know?
Yeah, no, we're good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So tell me more about your pussy.
Wow. Wow.
Come on, you guys. Don't be like that. Don't be
Time
like that.
Time for an anonymous pro like job.
Yeah, no.
Wow.
We're good. We're good. Oh, my God. You guys are being like this because yeah. I'm drinking, and you guys are like
drinking on a dating streaming service. I don't think I can get back.
Well, in. You gotta like nobody want knows. Like, do you, would a guy want a woman with a stinky pussy? No,
not at all. Well, when you mentioned you had a clean pussy. I just thought about
I shower daily. Yes, you gotta. Yeah. I shower daily. I keep clean, and
yeah, so
I even when I go to the washroom, I even wipe with wipes. Yeah. Like I keep clean. Yeah,
yeah
I don't.
So
need to, I don't need to see your cock. Keep it in your pants. Keep it
yeah,
in your
no,
pants.
I was just saying, I want to stick my cock in your pussy.
Okay, this guy is weird because, sir, I have conversations, very casual conversations on. The anatomy and the mindset of a woman. You just say whatever after some man says it. You just piggybacking off of what I did. I don't respect it, dog. I don't. I respect that she was honest, but you just taking it too far. Oh my god, because that did that. Like, dude, we don't care, man. I was just asking her a question. See if she can take a joke. You know, like, dude, you just ruined it, man. You guys are ruiners, man. Yeah, glasses guy is a 35-year-old virgin for sure, 100%. 100%. Oh, 100%, bro. I mean, I could go, let me see if we can go back.
I don't know that I like it.
Okay, like, I don't want to see it. So, like, just
keep... No, I'm not showing you. But do you like it when a guy masturbates?
Okay. That's enough. Mike, hello.
Oh, sorry.
Holy fuck, man.
This is what he was doing.
You guys.
He's gone. He's gone.
Holy fuck.
I don't think she's going to do it, but it would have been fun. He pulled his leg out.
I needed a drink.
Can't see anything, but it's just funny. This is what they're doing. So they go work at their careers. Then they come on the dating app and drink alcohol.
So while I'm even here. That's for sure.
He's hanging with his wanging. He's hanging with his wang out. Oh, let me see if there's any calls over here. He's hanging with his wang out. Oh my God, this is amazing shit. And this YouTube shit, man. I never thought I would be seeing and doing and observing this kind of stuff. Okay, let me see. Pulling out his wang. Lu Wang. That's his nickname, Lu Wang. Hey man, what's up? Oh, he did. Hold on. Let me see if we can get a call here. Nothing, bro. Nothing. Just betas on this shit. Okay, let's see. What's going on? What the f- So yeah, man, Diddy's in a bad trouble. He's in a bad situation. I mean, like Chuck Knight said, I don't want to see him in jail. But if you're violating women, they're just coming after you, bro. I keep my hands to myself, bro. So I said vagina's not at the top of my list. These guys make it like their whole personality. Vagina is my personality. Then I was wondering if they made a transgender superhero. What would you call them? Trans man. I was waiting for that one. They would call him the trans man. But really, no. His superpower would be he's not a man. He's really a female. That's the superhero, trans man. Someone should make a cartoon. Trans man. Okay, I guess there's nothing on that side. Okay, let's go back over here. Let's see.
I'm going to end that inbox for now. We're going to go do a verse. Okay. Who are we going to go battle?
Oh, she's doing that thing.
Just say hi to him for a minute.
Man put his wang in. Okay, let's go. I want to go nearby. And we'll continue on. But yeah, man, every day I'm starting this breaking down. It doesn't ever break down right away. It breaks down piece by piece. Everything is a catalyst for the destruction of society. That's what I'm starting to believe. So, you know what I'm thinking, bro? Oh, they're saying in Gaza, I was watching earlier before I came on. They're saying in Gaza, they have a food shortage in Gaza. They're saying children are dying in Gaza. Right? This was on Al Jazeera radio. They said there's a famine in Gaza, all kinds of stuff. People better hope that famine doesn't come over here. You want to really see chaos. You want to really see chaos. You got it. You got it. Okay, let's go down. Let's go to this lady. Did you see the Palestinian Indians in Edmonton pushing the cops around and carrying swords and spears? It's really a double standard for everything. Absolutely. Absolutely. The hard drugs, goblins, and hordes of hostile Indian men are dangerous.
Certified.
Absolutely.
Join.
Absolutely. What's going on?
I'm just chilling. What about you?
I'm just chilling. How old are you?
Holy. How old do I look?
Man, what do I have to guess? I'm just asking you.
Okay, so I guess. How old do I look?
19.
I'm 24, so.
You're 24?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you a wife?
Am I white?
No, are you a wife?
Oh, no.
So what are you?
Single?
Yeah, but I'm saying, do you just strive to be a wife?
Do I strive to be a wife?
Yeah, do you strive to be a wife? Do you want to be married one day?
One day, but to the right guy. I'm not wasting my time.
Have you ever had a hookup or a one-night stand?
I mean, I talked to them all before, like after, so it's not like it was just like...
So the answer is yes? Like
I'm in contact with all of them.
So the answer is yes?
Why does it matter?
So the answer is yes. So, man, that is wasting time. You're giving your vagina out and not getting anything in return. When you get older, all those bodies stack
except
up.
Money, bitch. Except money, bitch.
Excuse me, money from what?
Fuck off.
Oh, okay.
Like, I'm not getting interrogated. Are you good? Like, I'm kidding. I've never sold my pussy for money, but I'm not getting interrogated. Like, who do you think you are? You need a hut? I don't get it. If you want me to hear you, I don't get it. Because the way you're acting ain't gonna get you far, honey.
Look.
No.
Look, exactly.
Type it here. Certified.
No, I'll just move on. No, ma'am, I don't have to type it there because you say so. No, I don't. Bro, I told you. I'm doing the opposite of what they do, bro. Everything on everything. Everything. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We're going to do the opposite of what you believe? Yeah. By the way, man, more women are leaning left and more men are leaning right. That's it. Right? More. I can pull. Let me pull up the stats, actually. Fuck this. I'm going to. Hold on. Okay, this is by Pew Research. Voting patterns in the 2022 elections. In the midterm, 2022 in the midterm elections, there were familiar patterns, voting preferences among subgroups. Younger voters, black voters, and those living in urban areas continue to support Democrat candidates, while white and rural voters backed Republicans. But that's changing. You're talking about gender, yada, yada, yada. But here it is in 2022. So, what is the blue again? Share voting. 2022. Okay, so 44%. Yeah, look, men were voting Democrat 44%, women 51%. Men, or sorry, Republican 54% and women 48%. And then if you go black, 93% and they saying 5%. 93% Democrat and 5%. Let's see. So there it is there, man. Oh, and here it is here. So men voting Democrat is 50, women is 58. Republican 48, women 40. Women plus 18. The Democrat Party has gained plus 18 with women, plus 2 with men. But that's probably going to be different in this upcoming election. Okay, so going, okay, so Democrat, white men vote Democrat 43%. White men vote Republican 55%. White women vote Democrat 50%, white women vote Republican 48%, black men voting Democrat 92%, and then 6% Yeah, 6%. Right? So this is what it is. These are your numbers. Crazy, right? It doesn't matter at the end of the day. And there you have it. Oh, let's see what this one is. Right? So, bro, that number is going to change. Don't worry, that number is going to change. I know it's going to change. All right, so what do we got? Let's go back. It's going to be interesting. Okay, let's go back. Let's do a couple more. And then we'll cut it short. Okay, this is this. This is that. This is that. Okay, let's see. Yeah, so anyway, they're voting Democrat. That's the point. Women more likely will vote for Joe Biden because he's helping them. He's helping them with abortion rights. Yeah, I don't think so. He's pro, they're pro-abortion. They're eugenics. Eugenicists. They're eugenics. What's going on, man?
Hello.
What's going on? Why are you sitting in the dark?
I'm watching TV.
What you watching?
I'm watching a docuseries about children that are sentenced, like extended sentences, and how they are rehabilitated.
Do you like it when you get free stuff?
When I get free stuff?
Yes, and is feminism helping women in 2024?
Excuse me, what? Hold on, let me pause this.
Is feminism helping women in 2024?
Is feminism helping women in 2024?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not a feminist, so I don't know.
Are you a woman?
Yeah.
Are women oppressed in 2024?
I think in certain situations, but not in every.
Like what?
Like, I think it's bullshit that, like, as a woman, I would have to have my husband's permission in order to, like, do anything that would stop me from having children, even if it was, like, something that could potentially kill me.
I have no idea what you just said.
Interesting.
Do you have kids?
Yeah, I do.
How many kids do you have?
Two.
How come you're not with their father?
He's in prison.
Why'd he go to prison?
For trying to murder me.
You called the police? You called 911?
Yeah.
What'd you say to them? You just said, hey, he's trying to, like, take my life?
I mean, what do you say to the police whenever someone's trying to kill you? Yeah.
So you're a victim of domestic violence? You have a victim mindset?
Absolutely not, no. I used to, yes.
But you are a victim.
No, I'm not a victim. I'm a survivor. I don't think that I'm still a victim.
No, I think
I've healed
I think you're a victim, and there's nothing wrong. People are victims every day. But I think you're a victim that called 911 on her child's father because you know how to pick a good man in this country, right?
Sure.
Yeah, I don't think so, ma'am. I don't think you know how to pick a good man.
Oh, okay.
That's but guess good. What? I tell men worldwide not to put themselves in positions of what your baby daddy did. It's not worth it.
I agree.
It's not even worth it to have sex with you, to be in his position right now. It's just not.
Mm-hmm.
It's not.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, she healed from prison, Chad. Let me guess, you were attracted to the way he looks, right? But you weren't attracted to the way he treats you. Interesting.
No, that's not true.
All right. How long is he in jail for?
I mean, does it matter? He's in jail.
Yes, it does matter.
The thing is, whenever I got with my husband.
I'm a man that's not in jail having a real conversation with you. So it doesn't matter.
So what you're assuming is that my husband always treated me poorly, which isn't.
You were married to him?
Yes, I was.
Okay. What's your question?
It wasn't a question. It's fact. You assumed.
No, I don't think so.
No, you assumed that my husband was always bad to me and that I got married to him whenever he treated me poorly. And that's not the truth. The truth is my husband was in the military and
ma'am, that's what you're doing on this app? Just showing your ass? What kind of sense is this? Anyway, I appreciate it, ma'am, but you're just not on camera.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord, what? Who the asses deserve that shit? Like, you remember when I told you what happened?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it happened again this March, too.
Appreciate the different lights.
Different person. I swear to God. It's so good. It's all good, you know.
Yeah, we got seven likes. Thank you guys for liking the video. Appreciate it. Yeah, man, I do long streams. You know, this is a show that you gotta like get comfortable and kind of just relax. That's what I'm doing. I try to relax it a little bit. Okay, let's see if we can get in this call here. Yeah, we got 7 likes. If we can get to 10 likes, that'd be dope. All right, 10 likes on the video. I'm trying to average 10 likes each video when people, you know, with these high-profile cases, high-profile stories. Okay, let's go date. So, this lady.
Baby, I don't know why you see me.
She's not on camera. Oh, this lady? Oh, she still had me blocked. Okay, let's go. Let's see. So we talked to this woman. Let's talk to this woman. She's not on camera. I think we talked to her already. Yo, those are New York. Some of those New York chicks are wild, man. Some of these New York chicks are wild. Okay, we could go to, I think we clicked on her. Let's see. She's not on camera. So no. Let's go here. She's on the phone. Okay, let's go here. Shirley!
What's up, guys? Party hard.
What's up, Shirley?
Hi, Certified Truth. What's going on? Watching some. Oh, cool, man. All right, looks like we got a versus. Who's it going to be? Oh, hey. Oh, it's a box. Cool. What's going on?
What's going on, Shirley?
Turn that down a little before it echoes. Here we go. What's going on?
What's going on, Shirley? Where are you from?
I'm from Michigan. Where are you from?
I'm from Canada.
Oh, cool. Okay.
You ever talked to anyone from Canada before?
No, this is actually my first stream. So not here, but I have my mom streams and I know she's got a couple friends that she has added from Canada. So that's kind of cool.
Okay. Are you single?
I am.
Bra size.
Not going to go there. Thanks, though.
Story. You know what? This one counts as one of your adventures.
Hey, come on!
No freebies.
Oh, man, I wanted to go to Boob World!
Well, now we can't.
Thanks, ma'am. I'll be uploading.
girl.
You can't just put this shit in my face.
Anybody knows how to lose?
Like, Jesus Christ. Like, how are you a snowflake when you put it, you're presenting that? I'm going to present something, and then I don't want you to criticize.
If you're drunk enough to get it along with mine, till the night, until the night.
I'm the beta.
The sugar teacher. And finally drank away her.
Bro, these young men are lost today. Hopefully these streams help you
out. It literally sounds like a fucking porn store in fucking West 4th Street. Dave's 101 Vids. Does it not?
What's going on?
What's up, Certified Truth?
So what's going on? So Diddy was arrested. No, sorry. Diddy's home was raided. And he already paid his alleged victim $30 million. Why should they raid his home?
Are you really asking me for the answer, sweetheart? Because I don't know.
Okay. If you were victimized by a man and a man pays you, do you still want him arrested?
I mean, who else has been victimized by Regina George? I don't know.
You've been victimized by men?
And the teacher raised her hand. Have you ever been swallowed up? A couple days ago, yes. Yeah, no, maybe, sure. In one way or another. But, you know, we're getting divorced now, so whatever.
So, ma'am, you're getting divorced from your husband?
No, I'm divorcing him.
That's what I said. You're getting divorced from your husband.
No, you said from. From, meaning he's divorcing me.
I see why. Like, no shade, but I see why.
Something fast, something easy. Some dinner.
Man, get only fix much. If you're getting peace in your home, I don't tell you. You gotta get peace and common sense. That's why the men that are actually in long-term relationships, they got common sense.
Do you like yours to be like crispy, or do you like it just like?
I like soft? It like crispy, not black though.
Okay, I like mine kind of soft, just buttery.
Hey, it's a cooking show. You're cooking to men on a dating app, but not interacting with men on a dating app? I have no idea what that means. I don't know what this means. No soul in the eyes, my friend.
Whoever you are, certified, I don't accept.
Yeah, ma'am. You want me to give you some of my hard-earned money? For you to talk to me, I give you two middle fingers. That's it. You get nothing more than that. That's it. Have fun being an NPC and a zombie, being told what to believe, what to think, and cogs in a machine. Cogs in a machine.
Party.
Drywall on the walls and fluorescent lighting ahead of you and no privacy at all. What's the message? The message is really clear. You mean nothing. You are replaceable. You are a widget in a bin awaiting assembly. You're just a cog in a machine. You have no value.
That's the point.
I washed them in a washing machine.
Right? How the hell did we get here? I always wonder that. How the hell did we get here?
I need to get up with you.
How did we get to this, the brink of World War III, terrorist attack in Russia? And on and on and on it goes. Today, Diddy arrest. I just don't know how we got here. So she's watching cartoons on the date now. Wow. But that's the point, man. We got to.
I don't know for sure, no.
It's a dick.
I guess they say you're going to go online and create your own world, I guess. That's what I believe. That's what I believe.
You ain't gonna do shit.
Wait this weekend.
Cool.
I ain't gonna be this weekend.
Hello down there.
Our leftist.
I'll let you go out to drink this weekend.
Why would any man upload his head on a woman's body? I don't know, man. And that guy had the nerve to talk tough to me? Dog, you're just a cog, man. You're just a simple cog. There's a video of him, like, a woman, some girl putting makeup on his face. Bro, I would never put makeup on my face to come on YouTube. It doesn't make sense. You accept what I am or you don't. Keep it pushing. But not you. You think that you know. It looks significantly harder for you than it looks. Yeah, we can't get into some of these calls, man. Let's go this one. Go to that one. No. I think we talked to her already. So what's going on? Are you a cog in a machine?
What's that?
You don't know what a cog in a machine is?
Like, what do you mean by that, though? Elaborate.
I mean, do you live your life with value or do you live your life with value or no value?
I have value.
How so?
Well, I'm a single mother, so she comes first, and I value being a good mother to her. So I made myself better for my daughter.
So you think you're saying your daughter has the maximum parenthood when it comes to raising her or your child?
I put her first before anything else. So when I got pregnant with her at 19 or 18 and had her at 19, I put myself through college. I went to two jobs while in college. I raised her on my own. And
where's the father? Where's the father? Where's the daddy?
He lives in California.
How come you're not with him?
Ready? Hello?
Like, how does a man just give up his DNA like this? I'm not doing it. Unless there's no kids. But anyway. Why are you no longer with him? Why are you guys no longer in a relationship?
We broke up when I was pregnant.
So he broke up with you when you were pregnant? Why would he do that?
I broke up with him.
Wait a minute. So you get pregnant by a man, you get pregnant by your ex, and you break up with him. Why?
I broke up with him before I found out.
So you get pregnant by your ex and you break up with him. Why?
Because it's a long story.
Let me guess. He turned into a narcissistic. He was a monster. He was everything under the sun, right? That's evil.
No. He made very... Are you really streaming me on YouTube, bro?
So what's going on? What were you saying? I don't care, man. I don't listen to your trolls.
That's wild.
No, not really.
I was on this show.
All right? She shut down. Ma'am, you don't have to tell me. I don't care. It doesn't matter. I don't care what trolls say. Let's see. Think I care? You think I care? Wake up and feel what these little losers say?
Nothing.
What's going on?
Hey.
What's going on? Where are you?
At the nail shop.
Why are you there?
Getting my nails done.
Who paid for those?
Me. Because everybody else on this stream don't want to be nice.
Why should a man on this stream give you money? You're not his wife. You're not his girlfriend.
Because they're saying that they got it and then they don't got it.
I mean, yeah, that's true. They do say that. That means,
but I don't care. I don't need it. I'm just messing with them. I don't care. I could pay for my own stuff.
What do you do for work?
I don't do anything. I don't work.
You're unemployed?
Yeah, by choice, because I don't need to.
So basically the message on this app is unemployed women use this app to survive off of men that are working, so you work for her and you get nothing from her?
No. Because I don't need nobody's money.
You gotta help me.
I'm just on this app.
I'd be happy to help out. What can I do? Doodly 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 doodly
happy 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 So what are you doing? Who are you?
You need some help.
Let him go, Ralph. Yeah. He knows what he's doing.
I love Otto. I think I'm gonna upload some clips of Otto saying some dope shit. That's what I gotta do. I'm gonna upload some clips of Otto. Yeah, we gotta upload some Otto clips for sure. Yeah, we gotta upload Otto clips. So wait a minute, this woman's unemployed, doesn't have to roll up her sleeves to get work done, gets a phone, puts the camera on herself, and tells weak-minded, corrupt-minded simps and beta male or internet simps to give her money. Oh my God.
Who is trying
to donate that? Because you become a member, you have access to like-minded individuals. You get to have conversations, and you can come up on the show. And on top of that, I'm going to be building other infrastructure when I can, where we're all going to, you know, hang out at. This is a hangout session. And they're lucky I don't do it members only. But doesn't matter. But anyway, that's the message. That's the message. I finally figured it out.
I don't hang out with anyone, really. I don't hang out with people. NPC. Okay, beep, beep, what?
Look, the NPC.
I don't understand.
Right, she identifies as a cow.
I'm scared. I'm gonna get banned on here. Hey, JoJo. I know, I was just saying.
Yo, these young people today, not all, they call them the lost generation.
What?
Oh, well.
That's all we want.
Okay, let's see. But yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, you get to hang out with people, man. You get to have conversations. Once we get to where we need to be, I think we talked to her already. Right, we get to have conversations. We get to do different things. I would say this. What's going on, cowgirl?
Certified Truth TV. How you fucking doing?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
I didn't even see you fucking enter, which means you're probably gonna have some crazy ass shit, right?
Yep, I'm gonna have some crazy ass conversations.
Okay, let's do this shit. I'm ready for it. I'm all about it.
Okay,
don't be disrespectful. Disclosure number one. And we good.
Ma'am, I'm never disrespectful. I'm just
okay,
real.
Let's do this
and
shit.
And the truth can never be considered disrespectful, but does vagina clean itself?
Well, that is probably a specific to each individual.
Some women it does and some women it doesn't.
Well, I don't know that it cleans itself, but to some women, unfortunately, I've heard that they have issues with having to douche and do all that kind of shit. I've never had to do any of that. And my shit's fucking clean. And well, I'm a squirter, 5,000. So that's probably part of the process. You know, there's a lot of, you know,
right,
stuff going on.
Right.
Right. So that could be the reason why, but I've never had an issue with that. I've never had to do any kind of douche shit, you know, and my shit's clean as fuck.
How old are you?
Huh?
How old are you?
42. How old are you?
35.
Okay.
Do you think you hit the wall?
The wall of what? Like?
The wall of attraction. The sexual marketplace wall.
Fuck no. Not even close.
So you think you can, okay, you're saying that you can still attract the same guys that you could attract when you were 19?
100%.
Do you want a younger guy or an older guy?
I can have either one. And oopsies, my bad, sorry. What's up, Charles? How are you doing?
You said 42?
Tyson. Thanks. Thank you for the favorite. You can come back in. Let me reset this shit because I didn't mean to do that. I forgot. I don't do date box very often, so I forget all this shit.
42 lives in reality.
Get you back up in this bitch. Okay, you good. Let me date you right away. I'm sorry, my fucking bad. I forget all the rules and shit because I don't do date box a lot.
It's okay. What state do you live in?
Boise, Idaho.
Okay. So like
that.
If you got a man right now, would you can you he at? Treat oh, where am I? I'm in Canada.
Okay.
So if you got a man today, can he treat you like how Kanye treats his wife? He wants you to walk around half naked and he wants you to listen to what he has to say. You're here to support him.
So wait, can he or am I willing to allow that? Is that what you're saying?
Anything that can he and will he? Or would you allow
it? He can do whatever the fuck he wants. Will I allow it is a whole nother question.
Hey, will you allow him to do it? He says, yo,
no.
I want you to like, you know, today I want you to wear a nice little mini skirt when we're walking out, we're going into the Foot Locker and we're going to the
fuck no.
So he can't even say what he wants his wife to wear.
He can say whatever the fuck he wants. Will right. I allow it? Like, will I do it? Or will I allow him to say it? He can say whatever the fuck he wants. I will allow that. Will I do it is another question. So which question are we asking?
So if a man puts on a shirt that you don't like, would you tell him to take off the shirt? You said no?
No.
Okay. So you wouldn't, okay, he wears some weirdy, like some shirt that is like really ugly in your eyes. You wouldn't tell him to take it off?
No, I wouldn't tell him to take it off. Would I give him my opinion if he asked? Fuck yeah.
You just say, hey, I, you know, the shirt doesn't look good on you, whatever, whatever.
I would say I prefer another shirt. I don't like this particular shirt. I would be 100% honest, but not disrespectful or rude or like condescending or whatever, you know?
Okay. I respect.
What's up, Steve? How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Good.
How you doing?
Oh, fantastic. Just chilling.
Where are you at?
Nampa.
Oh, okay. That's right. You local. Please, I'm gonna go get Gatorade Zero. So you hold on 1 second. I know we got 1 minute and 38 seconds. I'll take like 20 of those. Hold on 1 second.
Right on.
I don't want to hear him. My favorite her? Yeah. I don't want to hear him. He has nothing interesting to say. Like most of them. So I'll move on. I don't want to hear him. It's pointless. It's meaningless to me. I mean, he's not going to say anything anyway. What's he going to say? He's going to have the googly oogly eyes. That's it. What's going on? Her connection's bad.
What happened?
What's going on? I can't hear you or see you.
I can't hear or see you.
Connection's trash. Connection's trash.
And what?
You want a girlfriend?
Yeah.
I don't mean a
friend. Is that you over there?
In this, but you ever been with dudes? Are you bisexual?
Huh?
Are you bisexual?
Sort of. I kind of went through the stages, but yeah.
Okay.
You would date a, what's going on? You would date a bisexual man?
Me personally, no.
How could you tell that the last guy you were talking to was bisexual or kind of soft?
That's why I asked him.
Oh, you could tell he was a little soft.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't judge people, but you know, I do ask my questions, you know.
I judge people based on their morality or their moral framework.
I'm very outspoken, so.
Yeah.
Would you date a bisexual woman?
A woman that likes another woman?
Yeah, bisexual.
Actually, no, because I've heard stories of women leaving their husbands to go and date another woman. So no. Absolutely not. No, if it was like, you know, having fun, eh, whatever.
You sound like a freaking, like, white man. You sound like a white man. I'm not even being racist or anything, but you sound like a white guy.
I sound like a white guy because I talk intelligent and I make sense of simple complexes.
I mean, if I close my eyes, I'm being very racially profiled. I'm very much so racially profiling you right now. But no, it's not a problem with that at all. It's just me looking at you and the voice and how you talk. I would not match it with you as your profile. So yeah.
Yeah, I don't think I sound like a white man. I sound like a strong black man. That's what I sound like. This is what a strong black man sounds like when he's winning, when he's educated, when he has knowledge, when he pursues the pursuit of truth. That's what a strong black man sounds like. That's why I'm presenting this to you right now. Huh?
Maybe I've just never heard it, huh?
Well, I mean, how did you grow up?
Where did I grow up? I didn't grow up around men talking like you.
You never grew up around men talking like me.
Yeah, as a black man, yeah.
That's what I said. And I get criticized, but
no,
I don't.
No, I'm not criticizing you here. I'm just saying.
No, not you. No, okay. Not you. Like, people, they criticize me because I walk my own path. I do a lot of internal deep thinking about situations and topics. So when I think about it, I'm like, okay, that has to be the pathway to it being right. So then I go with that. And people don't like me for it. And I don't care.
and that's your life. You know, I totally agree with you. I feel like it's not necessarily calling you out. I just feel like it's being more, just like I just said, being racially profiled, you know? Just like somebody could look at me and call me a hoochie or I'm on welfare or whatever. They don't know I have a career, you know what I'm saying? So
hello! You got a point.
Hi.
Where are you from?
No, she's
Alabama.
You're very beautiful. I'm just saying you're very beautiful.
Oh my God.
Thank you. You came in really hard. Like really
hard.
Came in really hard because I got an echo. I got an echo before I came in.
Oh, okay, nice.
So, echo, yeah.
Watch, I'm going to put it in the comment section. Watch this.
So I didn't get your age.
You didn't get my age?
Well, I'll check it out.
I'm 29. Most definitely.
You hear what I said?
You're 29.
Yeah.
He sounds like the black liberal Democrat. That's it. He's the guy Daniel you just talked to. He sounds like the black liberal Democrat. That's what he sounds like. He sounds like a person that is a black African American that voted for Joe Biden. That's what he sounds like.
I didn't even honestly pay attention to his voice.
Yeah, that's what he sounds like. But even I'll say this, even when I'm in my workplace or whatever, you know what I'm saying? The people that have this psychotic, twisted, gobbledygook mentality where they just believe whatever the narrative is, guess what happens? I avoid those people in the workplace. I just do my work, keep quiet, and focus on the path that I'm taking. That's it.
Can I see your face?
That's it. What do you mean, can you see my face? You can see me. Side of my face, look.
What are you looking up at, though?
I'm on YouTube, so that's why I'm looking at a system.
Oh, so you're streaming this right now?
Of course.
On YouTube?
Yeah, of course. Yes, ma'am, I'm streaming this conversation on YouTube. It's fair use. You have a problem with that?
I mean, I'm not getting paid for it, so
Yeah, it's definitely.
You're not getting paid for what?
I mean, you could be getting paid for it. Where's my cut? Where am I? You know,
maybe put it this way. Maybe one day I'd give you a cut if I was getting paid for it.
So you're not getting paid for it. How do I know that?
Well, go to my YouTube. I have Super Chat. I have all that stuff.
Oh, right? Okay.
But I'm not like, you know, when it comes to the money, you do or you don't. I'm not going to be on here begging for it. I'm just not doing that. I'm just not.
No one should beg for anything.
That's what I'm saying. But there's people that got to beg for it. And I'm just not doing that, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely without my consent. I feel like if you're going to, do you, should give people's.
No, not on this app. No, absolutely not.
Bad in the eyes of the fucking law.
Daniel again.
But still good in the eyes of like Daniel. Humanity and
like your family. Yeah, humanity exactly.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Daniel.
Class, in what year?
Certified Plus TV. How you doing? Welcome back.
Yeah. So what's going on, man? Do you have a high body count?
Big D Transport. How you doing? What's up?
More. Do you have a high body count? More than 10? Less than 20 people?
No.
Less than 10?
Not more than 10 and less than 20.
Okay, so in between. So under 10?
No.
So 15?
No, I said not more than 10 and less than 20. I don't fit in that range.
Okay, so under 5?
Not under that.
So it's above that?
Yeah. I'm looking for a girl who will let me smoke meth off her b-hole. What the fuck, Roy? Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here.
Do you want to be married one day?
I do.
Okay.
But, it is what it is.
Would you date what kind of man would you date? What does he have to have?
What kind of man?
Yep, what kind of man?
Okay. All right. So to be 100% honest, because we keeping it real up in this bitch.
Even if I wasn't in here.
So, and I do too. That's why the bold beauty is bold, like a motherfucker. So honestly, at the end of the day, the basic foundation is a man that loves God. I know it's a little hard for people to believe because I've gone up and down and in and out with my relationship with God.
Yeah.
But to be married to a man, that is 100% the basis of my foundation would be a man that loves God and has a relationship with God.
Yeah.
And the next step, of course, thank you for the favorite. What's up, Roy? What's up, Daniel? So, come back. Y'all come back. Y'all should be in fucking line. Like, you're supposed to be coming back. So, the fuck?
That's crazy. Daniel! Daniel!
I love God, too, just so you know.
Huh?
I love God, too.
I love God, too.
I agree with everything.
So, I'm a drywall on the walls and fluorescent lighting ahead of you and no privacy at all. What's the message? The message is really clear. You mean nothing.
So I'm not like one of those lawyers that are now.
You are a widget in a bin awaiting assembly. You're just a cog in a machine.
I'm definitely not that. I'm not a fucking like hypocrite. I'm not. That's not me.
Anyway.
I'm 100%. I'm a sinner saved by Christ.